Lewis. Snap goal. He's got it.
It goes bang. How good was that? Into the jungle.
Yes, welcome to the Virgin Australia Sunday Soapbox. A big day for Tex Walker. First game as the Crows captain. He's had a big build-up. He was injured the year before last, came back. And so is Andrew Swallow, and he's in his fourth season as North Melbourne captain. A lot expected from both these clubs this year. North maybe again pushing for top four, and the Crows maybe back into the eight. Well, the soapbox lead, the big issues from Lee Matthews. Welcome to the Adelaide Oval, by the way.
Isn't it great for football to be back? The downside, of course, is there's already five teams that are going to have a downer because they lost this round, but that's what's going to be happening now for the next 6 months.
Just some late news. Ben Brown's out for North Melbourne today in their match against Adelaide. So Ben Jacobs, one of the emergencies, come in. So that's the news. Let's go back to Thursday night. Let's start with that. It was Richmond over Carlton. Revolt gets four. What does that mean?
It means Richmond usually win. They won by 27 points. I think Richmond are a better side than Carlton in this year's competition. And again, Revolt, when he kicks his four, Richmond are always going to be somewhere near their better performance. So they were good. Melbourne, they were outstanding. They were the real surprise packet so far of the weekend. I mean, they kicked 17 goals, a really good performance against a pretty disappointing Suns outfit. Looked a bit soft on the day.
This was an amazing match. I mean, the scoreline was just so hard to read, but then in the end, capitulated.
We'll talk about it a little bit more briefly, but I think it was also went with what you thought might happen. High emotional performance by Essendon early, but faded late.
I didn't think they'd be seven goals in front of the Swans.
No, I don't think it'd be that far in front.
And Collingwood also had a big lead, but they hung on.
Yeah, 53-point lead just before three-quarter time, and the Lions had a bit of a surge in the last quarter, but Collingwood were just a bit cleaner. They had two big forwards that won in the game.
And for the Dogs, a 10-point win.
Yeah, but a 10-behind win. So they had 10 more scoring shots. So that was a good effort by them to get over the top of the Eagles, who've lost another of their big defenders, Mitch Brown.
Yeah, they've had shocking luck, haven't they, the Eagles, with injury. Lee, your list for today, and this will be a feature of the Virgin Australia Sunday Soapbox. So go through them.
Well, we'll have a look at the games to this point. The summer recruiting, we get the first look at it, but we can have a summary of it. The new look match review panel, that's interesting. There's been an upgraded version of that process. Jude Bolt and I are both going to build our team from scratch. More importantly, the type of player that you pick first, second, third.
Looking forward to that.
And Patrick Dangerfield we'll have a talk about because he's this year's potential. Will he stay or will he go?
OK, let's start with the matches. Richmond and Carlton, what took your eye here?
Well, it had to be the first gamer, Camden McIntosh. I mean, I'd never seen him play before. Most of us hadn't. He's been around Richmond for a while. He's a 21-year-old, and he's big and he's strong. Looks a little bit like Shane Tuck, who just retired from the club a year or two ago. But he was just really, really impressive, really impressive. So that was the thing, I think, that came out of the game the most.
What's the best debut you've seen?
Oh, Dermot Brereton, 1982, way back now, semi-final against North Melbourne. Dermot, first game, he just turned 18, so he's a teenager, a skinny teenager at that point. Kicked five goals in a semi-final. That was a fantastic first effort from a very, very young player.
That was Thursday night. No footy Friday. Good thing or a bad thing?
I think it's time. I mean, I think the religious sanctity of the day, I think that's valid. But I don't think there's any problem now in having a game of football sort of later in the afternoon into the evening. It's happening in all the other sports. And I just don't... I think the AFL are now behind the curve. And usually they're in front of the curve. So I think Good Friday football, I think we're ready for it.
Jesse Hogan, how many first game players for Melbourne were there?
Melbourne had seven players who've never worn the Melbourne jumper before. I mean, a handful of them were first gamers in the competition. About four of them, I think. But Jesse Hogan, we've heard so much about him because he's been injured for a couple of years, but I always think when I see a player for the first time, you get a first initial impression. He looks a big, strong forward and they win your games.
You were impressed?
Oh, yeah, really impressed. He was really good. And Angus Brayshaw, who was third pick in the draft last year, he looks a really mature 18-year-old as well. So they look like they've picked up a couple of really good draftees, when for the last decade or so, a lot of their draftees just haven't really come through.
So big tick for Melbourne. Gary Ablett's shoulder, I mean, tell us about that and his game.
Well, he didn't look like he had confidence in his shoulder. I don't know whether he actually fell on the point of it. He all got tackled on the point of it. And I mean, I don't think he's got confidence in his shoulder. And unfortunately, if Gary doesn't have a really good day, I don't think the Suns are going to have a good day either. It was interesting, later in the game, he went for Viney and Garland tagged him pretty well. And when he's not getting the ball, he tends to want to get into the back half and sort of just get those easy possessions. But if he's playing centre, forward, not getting 40 possessions. Get that out of your mind, Gary. Get 25 or 30 and kick three or four goals, which he's capable of. Suns will be a much better team.
You never went into the back half, did you? You don't want
to... No, you never get to be player of the century going into the back 50, Mac. Well, I told you that. No one takes any notice of those back 50 kicks.
You should be the prototype for Gary. Anyway, you'd like to see him more forward.
Well, I think so.
You think 20 possessions might be as good as 35 if they count?
As long as you're actually forward and centre. Yeah.
The bonding for the Bombers. I mean, you touched on it a moment ago. Can you talk us a little bit more through that and this match?
Well, I'm a great believer in bonding through shared adversity. And that's why players train hard together, because if you have adversity and you share it, it's amazing how it just bonds the team. Now, Essendon have had a tough couple of years, the players waiting to see what happened with the ASADA investigation. So it's no surprise, even though they'd played no pre-season, most of these guys, they just produced something that physically they should not have been capable of producing. Just completely overwhelmed the Swans the first bit of the game. But they were so extreme in that emotional upper in the first half that come the last quarter, physically they're fading, but I think emotionally they're fading as well. And the Swans kicked 7-6 to nil in the last quarter to win the game. So extreme examples, I think, but really good early and really bad late is not surprising when you think about the way they went into the game, Essendon.
The AFL Tribunal's decision, re-Essendon, justice done, do you believe?
Yeah, I think so, to be honest. I mean, the governance issue of what the Essendon players were given and all that kind of stuff. Essendon got punished 18 months ago. James Heard got suspended for a year, got paid for it. I don't know how that happened, but he did. And so there was a lot of penalties, and there'll be a lot of litigation in the future, I suspect, of Essendon players who might well sue Essendon for what did happen, what did I get given. But the players got off, which I think everyone thought they should have, because if anything, they were innocent victims. So I think, in a sense, there's been a bit of a fair justice if nothing happens from this point on.
And Stephen Dank, when's he going to court?
He's not going to court. Every time I pick up a paper, Stephen Danks is going to sue someone for defamation. Getting into a court under oath and cross-examination, I don't think Stephen Dank is wanting to... We want him to do that, because then you might know what happened, but I don't think he's going to be into that.
Tom Boyd and the Bulldogs.
Yeah, that's interesting. I mean, the Bulldogs won last night, won well. Tom Boyd had a couple of marks, kicked a goal. They can't believe this 19-year-old is on a $7 million contract for 7 years. Like $1 million a year. Like 12 months ago, when Lance Franklin, a 27-year-old bona fide superstar, was on $1 million for 9 years, I thought that was reckless. Because you do the mathematics. He has to be playing at 36 and be worth $1 million a year. But this is an unproven kid. I just can't believe this is putting your head in your... I just hope this doesn't work, because it encourages other clubs to be reckless as well.
Are you worried about that, Mark?
I think it's just a terrible principle. He's getting 10% of the Bulldogs' salary cap. And he has to be Franklin, Jonathan Brown, Wayne Carey rolled into one just to justify what he's getting as an unproven player. So, no, I think it's really dangerous recruiting, that one.
OK, if that's dangerous recruiting, the highest profile recruit was Beams.
Yep.
But I probably want to ask you about the three that sort of came together.
Yep.
Clark, Lumumba and Varko.
That's the one really interests me, because really they usually play as a swap for draft choices, so you've got to wait and see what happens. But Clark for Lumumba, Varko, that was all a three-way swap. Lumumba will be good for Melbourne, he's a good player. Varko was pretty good for Collingwood last night, he's OK. But Mitch Clark, now if he's physically or mentally right, he is a gigantic pickup, because he's a good big forward, he's a really good ruckman, and the big forward who can be a goal kicker in that position to support Tom Hawkins, and he can go into the ruck as a second ruckman. Fantastic. He's been unpredictable, physically and mentally, clearly. But if he's on, that's a great pickup for Geelong.
He gets a thorough examination tomorrow. He's playing against Hawthorn.
Well, he is playing against Hawthorn. Probably James Frawley, who's the free agent pickup that Hawthorn got from Melbourne.
Match review panel. That was on your list, Lee. Yep, I mean, this is a document that we were all given in the media. And what have you read from this?
Well, this is the document that the panel makes their decisions on. What do we know? Basically, the point system is gone. There's no points. So the players are either going to get a fine for a really minor offence, or they'll get weeks. One of them. No carryover points. And what it does is simplify the system. I didn't think the old system was that bad, but it was complicated. And the fans couldn't really understand it, and therefore the fans have to be able to understand it, because the fans are really the lifeblood of the game. So I think it's a really good updated version of the judiciary system.
Well, two incidents from the weekend. Let's start with Brett Deledio.
Well, the Brett Deledio one, whenever you bump from the front with a player over the footy, there is also a principle that an incident that could create serious injury is really more harshly looked at.
And here's Matt Shaw.
And that's coming front on in the marking contest. Errant arm, blow to the face. The way I look at those, that there's more damage done by Shaw on Kent, but I think because of the risk of damage with the Deledio one, I think both of them will be careless. It's either careless or intentional. So careless, high impact, high contact. 3-week penalties for both of them, but you still get the week off for the guilty plea.
So two.
So I think they'll serve 2 weeks each. And that's the way I read it from my...
And are you comfortable with that?
I think that's a good enough outcome.
Good stuff. I'm really looking forward to this building a team. You and Jude Bolton, about how you've gone about that. So both the teams out there for the moment, North Melbourne and the Adelaide Crows. A reminder, yesterday's huge meeting in Sydney was postponed. We know that the championships and the $10 million day is on tomorrow on 7. The championships from Royal Rambling. Shows and movies, and where and where you want them, from presto.com.au, a 30-day free trial. Nick Revolt here, getting a goal in the early match that's being played at the moment. Now, Nick, of course, lost his sister pre-season. We were all sad when we saw Jack's reaction on the weekend, his cousin. So Fight Like Maddie is the theme for Nick through the year. So at the moment, the Giants lead by 20 points, but Nick Revolt, a great leader and a great guy. Jude Bolton joins us on Virgin Australia Sunday Soapbox. Jude, welcome.
Yeah, thank you very much.
One heck of a match out here today.
Should be a brilliant game. Really looking forward to it. Two highly contested teams and wanting to bounce back from last year.
Well, both you and Lee have gone about building a team, a really strong team. Lee, I'm going to start with you first. I mean, where did you start?
Always start with the best key forward in the game, and I think that's Franklin at the moment. So you're always going to pick him first if they're all lined up against the wall. I mean, he's such a wonderful, flexible player. He can play anywhere, centre forward. He's not just a big, strong full forward like Tom Hawkins or players of that ilk. He's just such a good player. If you're going to have a key forward, didn't you go to the other bookend? I think the key defender. I went for Harry Taylor after seeing Alex Rance the other night, almost changed my decision. But Harry Taylor has just been the outstanding key defender. Get your bookends in place. Now you start building your midfielder. Ablett is just the best midfielder. He just gets the ball so often. He's prolific, he's damaging. So you just sort of put your weapon in there. Luke Hodge, he's the best on-field general I've seen since Michael Voss, and that's saying something, because Voss, he was outstanding. Just that ability to control what's going on around him. So you get one of those in your team. Then a Joel Selwood, who just, I think, is still one of the best in-tight players of the whole bunch, has been for a lot of years, so he's been terrific. I would top my team up with him. Then I'd go to a bit of versatility in your height. Jared Ruffhead, I think, is the most versatile tall in the game. He can play full forward, centre half forward. He can ruck. He can even go ground level centre bounce. And then just to top it off, seeing we had only 7 to pick, Nat Fripp, a tall midfielder, the midfielder who can jump in the air and take an overhead mark, as well as being a really good constructive ground level player.
No salary cap problems for you?
I think you'd have a lot of salary cap problems. That'd be
everyone else on a pittance.
And Jude, what about you? I mean, how do you match up with Lee?
I went a different tack. I believe it's won and lost in the midfield week after week. So I just assembled the best midfielders around at the moment. And midfield forward, the most dominant player is Buddy Franklin. He just does what other players just cannot do on the ground. And he was shown that last night. Gary Ablett, arguably the best player in the game at the moment, and he's my midfield weapon. I'd assemble him in my lineup and build the team around him. Number 3, I've got Patrick Dangerfield. He's an inside grunt player, but he's got pace to burn on the outside. Also throw him as that lead-up full forward type as well, and just lucky to be probably up as high because he's not as successful. Luke Hodge. You know, dual Norm Smith medalist, triple premiership player, as you mentioned, Lee, defensive general. He'd play in defence for my mind, in my side. And then Joel Selwood, hardness, consistency, leadership. He's got it all, and he's played in big games and performed so well. Number 6, I've gone with Josh Kennedy, a clearance specialist, probably one of the hardest players to tackle in the league at the moment. He just walks the tackler and he's able to feed out to my runners as well on the outside. And then lastly, you know, Lee mentioned him, Nat Fyfe. He's just so good overhead, but he's also just got the ability in time and space to think his way through it and deliver and execute. And I just think, you know, there's a couple of similarities there, but I'd built it more around midfielders, no defenders as such in mind. But I'd be thinking, you know, because of everyone plays team defence as such, you can push up on them, force the ball around there, and I'd maybe pick up an Alex Rance or a Josh Gibson just outside that top seven.
So five the same and a couple of different. Looking at Jude Lee, do you feel like he's done a bit...
I say sometimes midfielders win the medals, but they're a dime a dozen. There's about 40 terrific midfielders in the competition.
Pendlebury and those.
That's why I always want to build. I want to build a team from having two or three bookend players, big, strong players, because you've always got a lot of... let's face it, in this, when we're picking only seven in the whole competition, you're leaving out great players. But I'm probably topping him up with a bit more height.
I think Rance has probably just stepped in front of Taylor for mine at the moment. Yeah, his ability and also to play on someone like a Buddy Franklin, his versatility is unbelievable.
Because it was a fairly mature list from both of you.
Yeah.
Did Robbie Gray enter your thoughts at all?
Absolutely.
He's around the mark, definitely.
As a midfield forward goal kicker, which I think is a really valuable type of player. That's why I mentioned a Gary Ablett can be a midfield forward goal kicker, and Robbie Gray already is that.
Yeah, exactly. And he's also the score assist. He just provides such an option up forward.
And I've got to ask, were either of you tempted to put a ruckman in?
I know Lee's thoughts on this. He doesn't rate them, but we used to say tap it and get out of the way, to be honest.
Okay, fair enough.
There's no ruckman good enough to be in about the first 30, I don't reckon, Macca. You have to have one in the team, I take that back.
But not in your set. Okay, Patrick Dangerfield was in Jude's team. I want to ask you about Patrick Dangerfield and how this year might play out. What should happen, do you think?
Well, the industry thinks he's either staying at the Crows or going to Geelong. No other club in the competition is even, I don't think, talking to him, because it seems one or the other. Go home to Geelong because that's the area that he comes from. If I was Patrick Dangerfield, I reckon I'd be doing exactly what I'm doing. If he knows what he's doing and he's staying at the Crows, OK, that's fine. But if he's intending to go to Geelong, I'd just be doing what he's doing and saying, well, I'll continue to think about it and I'll let the uncertainty be there. Because we know it happens in other sports, Jude. But
really interesting, though, to see that they didn't give him the captaincy in the off-season. Like, to pick Taylor Walker, it says to me that either they're preparing for him to walk away from the club or it's just a decision to say it's not about you, it's about the team, and that's what Phil Walsh is about. It's about the team.
Well, you live in Sydney and Lee lives in Brisbane. In the NRL, we know in advance when players are going to another club. You don't like that idea?
I don't like it at all.
I know it becomes normal, but it's abnormal in the AFL. So if I was Patrick Dangerfield, I wouldn't be the first to do it.
Let someone
else be the bunny who comes out first.
So do you think we'll ever see it in the AFL?
I think they should fight not to have it in the AFL. It's something that really hurts the NRL.
Lee said it's only Geelong because of the home thing, or Adelaide. Which other club, though, do you think should be chasing?
I think someone like an Essendon should be pulling out all stops to get after him, because, you know, he could match up with someone like a Heppel inside. Joe Watson's past 30, Stanton and Goddard are both 29. You know, that's the sort of midfield that you want to start to build around to, say, a Heppel.
And one last thing on Dangerfield. Could it be distracting for him this year, do you think? I mean, how do you see him handling it?
Well, it's distracting. It is distracting because the uncertainty hangs in the air and he gets asked about it regularly, and his teammates probably get asked about it regularly. So it is distracting. But I think it's more distracting if he came out and said, I'm going to be at Geelong next year.
Yeah, Ablett was able to play with the best guys.
He never said he was going.
Some of the best can buy.
Franklin was the other one that sort of...
He knew he was going, but he didn't say it.
Yeah. No. The last words with you, Lee, on the Virgin Australia Sunday soapbox. And what's coming from Lethal's lips today?
Well, I think in the AFL's illicit drug policy, I think it's time for the AFL to be a real community leader in the campaign against illicit drugs. Now, the current policy is really about player welfare, so you don't get penalised till you've done a third offence. First offence is cancelling, second offence, positive test we're talking, is cancelling, and then you finally get a penalty. Gary Pert, the Collingwood CEO, said something, great analogy to me. The laws of demerit points. Mm. I mean, 12 demerit points, you lose your licence. You only really, really worry about speeding when you've got 9 or 10 demerit points. Mm. In other words, I think if I'm an AFL player, I know there's no problem until I get tested for a third time and found positive. I think we've got to tighten it up. I think there should be a penalty for the first offence. It might be a 2-week penalty. It might be simply announce the player and a public reprimand. But either way, I think we need a penalty for first offence as a real deterrent I put the player welfare a little bit secondary to the community leadership on the issue.
Clubs are arguing also that they are best positioned to actually deal with the problem internally and actually deal with it if they're knowing about it. But also, we've got to remember it's a voluntary system, so if it's pulled in and reined in too much, the players just say, no, we'll just fall underwater.
Just quickly, do you think with everything that's happened in the last couple of years and last 2 weeks, we will see a change in the illicit
policy? I think so. I think this is 2005 is the current policy went, and I think a lot of things have changed since then, and I think the awareness, it has to be a community war against illicit drugs, and the AFL have to lead it, I think, is much more prioritised right now in their thinking.
There needs to be a serious change. They'll change it very soon, and Gil McLaughlin's already stated that.
OK, good stuff. Really enjoyed that. So the Virgin Australia Sunday Soapbox. So we get ourselves set for what should be a great game of footy. It's round one, but round one has a life all of its own, as we so well know. So North Melbourne, top four last year. We sort of forget that slightly, don't we? Mm. Rory Sloane ran into his parents today, Brandon and Sandy. They were having a coffee where I was, and they said that Tex Walker's really nervous today, but they're looking forward to a big game from him. So looking forward to the two teams coming out. They'll be doing that very, very shortly. Bets over 50 goals last year. Will it be Bets or will it be Thomas at the other end? So many good duels, including Jacobs versus Goldstein, right in the middle. All eyes on Dangerfield and Walker, and of course for North Melbourne, their litany of stars. Coming back with the teams coming out just after this.
It's the beginning of a new era in Adelaide. Today, rookie coach and master tactician Phil Walsh takes control.
At the back, Walsh and a screamer. The
Walsh was a talented wingman for Collingwood, Richmond and Brisbane back in the 80s. But now, it's at the Crows where he's looking to make his mark, putting the entire list on notice on day one.
Success doesn't come looking for you. You got to chase it.
The Crows have a star-studded midfield and a potent forward line, but it's in defence where Walsh's men will thrive in 2015. The back six, led by reigning best and fairest Daniel Talia, will undergo a massive test first up against last year's preliminary finalist, North Melbourne. A second finals appearance saw North confirm to the football world what Brad Scott already knew.
Oh, that is brilliant!
That his Kangaroos are a force to be reckoned with.
Snap goal! He's got it!
Big wins against the Bombers and the Cats in September proved just that.
That is a beautiful kick.
Their challenge now is to back it up. The veterans are primed, last year's revelations are ready, but it's the new faces many believe hold the key to North's top four chances. Jared Waite and Sean Higgins bring over 300 games of experience. A new season brings new hope. For today's combatants, hope is burning bright.
Yes, you feel like they have recruited them. Maybe take that next step up. Got to a prelim last year. In comes Higgins, in comes Waite. They're a very experienced team, an exciting team, North Melbourne. Hard to get a handle on. They've never won a round one match under Brad Scott, but they won't be thinking about that right now. Lindsay Thomas, the goal-kicking forward, as we welcome you to the Adelaide Oval, Sunday footy with Jude Bolton and also Lee Matthews. What's your take on these two teams?
Well, I think North Melbourne, they got the fourth spot last year, but I think they'll be doing well to maintain their fourth spot ranking, to be honest. I mean, they've recruited Jared Waite, experienced, very a veteran. Crows, 11-11. I'm not sure where they're going, up or down.
Oh, I think the Crows list is actually primed. I think that they've underperformed, and as we've seen, it, you know, this team, North Melbourne, actually stopped their run at the finals last year, and that's what, you know, cast the last stone on Sanderson's career, I guess, as well. So two lists that are primed, and North got their spike and jump last year. Let's see how they go.
It looks an even money game. We're going to find out a lot about the two teams today. We're going to find out a bit more about Phil Walsh too as we go on. I mean, 20 years an assistant, but we didn't really get to know him. But now as a senior coach, we are.
I think there's an element of weirdo in all of us as people who want to be senior coaches and put themselves under this sort of microscope.
Coming through is Walsh. A hand pass from Walsh to Richardson. Back to Walsh again. Can the Collingwood winger score? It's a great goal! Philip Walsh!
I grew up in country Victoria and it was such a part of the community, playing footy in the morning and in the afternoon going down and watch the Hamilton senior team play as well. So it's been in my blood for a long time. I just love the game. When I finished playing, I got a job at Geelong as a fitness instructor, so it was a part-time job then. And then slowly being the runner as well, it was a nice go-between the coaches and the players. And then I was lucky enough to get asked by Mark Williams to come and join his coaching panel in Port Adelaide. Yeah, I've had a long journey with coaches because I played at three clubs, Collingwood, Richmond and Brisbane. My first coach was John Cale, who was a great motivator. Probably the first coach who probably had some structure and organisation was Robert Walls when he coached me at Brisbane. And then I got to work alongside Gary Ayres at Geelong, Mark Williams and John Worsfold, and I've taken things from all those three coaches. The most important stat as a senior coach is what the scoreboard's telling you.
Gives it to Sloan. This is for nine. Strikes it okay. Super goal again.
I'll never lose my passion for the game. I coached at West Coast when we finished last. It's still one of the most enjoyable years I've ever had in football. So I can still find enjoyment because this is where my passion is.
Done his apprenticeship and not young to be getting a senior job.
Heaven forbid other Crows trying to emulate Port Adelaide. He's the Ken Hinckley model, isn't he? Been an assistant coach for a long time. Now he's finally got his chance at senior level.
Speaking of Port Adelaide, when Phil Walsh made Tex Walker the captain, I kept thinking about Warren Treadrake, Port Adelaide, and he was there at the time. And I think he sees some similarities in what Walker might be able to do as a big forward as captain of the club.
He's so influential. He brings the team along. And when he's up and about, and this is some of his form in 2012, to be honest, and, you know, he was able to kick 63 goals in 2012. And just he gets his teammates up.
This is the one part of the game, Jude, where I reckon midfielders are better equipped to be leaders. I don't like the big forwards as a leader, just as a general rule. He might be the best that Adelaide have got. And he was the best team man, won the best team man award last year. So he's obviously really regarded around the club. But I always find it's hard to lead out of the forward third when all the pressure is in the back half.
Did you tell Jonathan Brown that when you were...
Well, that's why Jonathan Brown didn't become captain immediately. Michael Voss retired.
It is hard, though. You want to influence the game, so you want to get yourself inside the middle.
Yeah. Eddie Betts is not going to be captain, but what he does really well is kick goals. And one of them last year was the finest and the goal of the year against North Melbourne. But he's been brilliant for Adelaide, as he was for Carlton.
He kicks the odd ground-level goal, but both him and Lindsay Thomas up the other end for the Kangaroos, they're target players. They're only small guys, but they will get on the lead to make themselves available for teammates upfield. So I always look at Eddie as a small full forward, really.
He does present well. He's leading mark all the time. And I guess they've got Charlie Cameron up there as well, who's a different type of player, but, you know, very sharp inside 50. Mm.
In a word, who's better, Thomas or Betts?
I'm going Betts.
OK. They're similar.
They're very similar.
OK.
Very similar.
Let's talk about the Kangaroos for a moment. We talked about their recruitment, Higgins and Wade are two that come in. Now, Higgins can play both ends. Wade can do it too, but probably as a forward, what difference can they make?
I think they're sort of the missing pieces, to be honest, but we don't know exactly how consistent these two can be. At their best, absolutely damaging, especially Higgins. And we've seen in the NAB Cup, he was able to kick three goals on one occasion. You know, he can turn teams inside out and give you a bit of flexibility, but he's got to be consistent.
It looked like he'd gone off the ball at the Bulldogs the last few years, so I guess they all hope the change of coach.
Here's the jumper to Waite, by
the way. He'll find his best, yeah. And Jared Waite has been... there he is. It's been about as inconsistent as you get, to be honest. I mean, his best fantastic and his worst has been pretty poor. So, but with Petrie, that big post forward, the big forward, having the running, marking, centre forward type player, well, they really haven't had a good one. Waite might become that.
He's got to eliminate the brain fades, though.
And durability has been a problem for both. They've both been injured a whole lot. A couple of newcomers there, Basil, but from a Crow's point of view, you've got your eye on a veteran today.
Bruce, good afternoon. Yeah, terrific to be here. A little bit of cloud about, slight wind, but terrific conditions for round one. Nathan Van Berlo, that's right. We talked about the new captain of the Adelaide Crows in Tex Walker. Well, of course, Nathan Van Berlo, captain of the club for five seasons, unable to play all of last year because of that ruptured Achilles. He's a real leader at this club still, and it's terrific for the Adelaide Crows to welcome him back. He's the big in, I guess, the sentimental in many ways. The other up there in the back pocket, number 25, Kyle Cheney, 41 games at Melbourne and Hawthorn, including nine last year, a premiership year for the Hawks, and they're hoping some of that premiership feel can rub off on this Adelaide Crows lineup, even though obviously he did not play. But Adelaide looking good. Of course, starting there, His 20th season is a man who's been around, well, it feels like forever, doesn't it? 20 years of football, it's quite incredible. Boomer Harvey wearing the number 29 Guernsey. He played his first game against the Adelaide Crows 19 seasons ago. He kicked 2 goals that day, and all these years later, the Adelaide Crows players still nominate him as the North Melbourne player they need to watch.
For the last probably 25 years with the Kangaroos, stop Brent Harvey.
Harvey and Yetch, the old and the new. Oh, he speeds away, bounces inside 50 and says that's how it's done.
He's so good. He's an incredibly important player for them.
Although he's pretty old, he's probably one of their best players.
He's that evergreen midfielder that just gives them so much drive and so much run.
The little man Harvey, an opportunity here, and he turns around.
Boomer Harvey in season number 20. He's been around a long time. 5th player to make it to season number 20. He first played against Adelaide in round 12, 1997. And as I mentioned, he kicked 2 goals. North Melbourne on their way out. Let's get back upstairs to Bruce.
Thanks, Basil. Terrific. And Brad Scott's joined us. Brad, thank you for doing that. Hey, Brad, firstly, good luck. But can I ask you the late change? Jacobs in for Brown?
Yeah, Bruce, a difficult decision. We just decided that we'd go with our fittest list and those who had had the best preparation and probably a little bit of going a little bit smaller too. We really feel that round one's high intensity and we want our best running side available. And Brown's been OK in the pre-season. He's going to play a big part in our 2015 year, but we feel like a running side's called for today.
Brad, I'm still trying to get used to recruiting your 31-year-olds. Jared Waite, of course, has come into your lineup and he's been terrific at his best, but he has had his bad days. What have you found the key to trying to get his optimum level?
Oh, not yet, to be honest, Lee. I mean, I've spent a lot of time with Jared over the pre-season. It's going to take us a while to get to know him, but, you know, I'm a big fan of looking at what players can do rather than what they can't, and I think the focus of Waite's career, people have focused too much on what he can't do.
Brad Dugan here. You're really the first person to coach against Phil Walsh. What are you expecting from Phil and the Crows today?
Well, we can only judge on what we've seen in the NAB Challenge so far, and that's a really well-organised, high-pressure team, and probably reflective of Phil's time at West Coast in 2012 and, you know, his recent experience at Port Adelaide. So we're expecting a contested game, a really high-pressure game, and we're up for it.
Good on you, Brad. Exciting times for the club and an exciting opening round. All the best, mate.
Appreciate it. Thanks, guys.
Thank you to Brad Scott. But Boomer Harvey, it is amazing that the bloke, and of course Dustin Fletcher played yesterday, but it's crazy, isn't it?
Is he 40 yet, Dustin? He's 40 this year, isn't he?
They're a week apart, by the way. I mean, Dustin turns 40 a week before Boomer turns 37.
But a 40-year-old who's about to be playing AFL footy, and Brent Harvey obviously is 384 games, he's 37, isn't he? Just, it's amazing, there's two real veterans.
Dustin has 14 of his teammates who hadn't debuted before he's, you know.
The key for both, I think, is that physically they haven't lost their pace.
Well, that's right. I mean, Boomer Harvey's probably still the player you want to stop in the North Melbourne lineup. I mean, if he runs and carries, which he still is able to do, you just forget the birth certificate in a way, because the ageing process, he's defied that for a long time and continues to do so.
They are a rather old team, to be honest. I mean, they've got a lot of blokes over 30, haven't they? Half a dozen playing today.
That's why I reckon they've gone for the Waite and the Higgins, trying to get just this, while it's the pieces here, their window's open, they're trying to cash in right now.
Well, Waite you virtually get for nothing because he's a free agent. It's not as if you have to give away a draft choice. So it's almost a free pick in a way. All you're doing is paying him whatever salary he's getting out of the salary cap. But DeSanto came in a couple of years ago. So they're a very experienced team, aren't they? That's the point.
And they've got that group of midfielders that all came in about the same time. Yeah, I'll say two names, Zeeble and Cunnington, who you feel like have got to a level, and they may even go to one level above that and maybe get into your top seven.
Well, they're still only the mid-20s. They're just really in the prime of their career these days. Big, big, strong player, Jack Zeeble.
So a big moment here for Tex and his team.
Exciting, incredibly exciting to lead your team out for the first time.
I know it's probably ridiculous as I go through, but I feel there's more pressure on Adelaide today. They were 6-6 at this ground last year. They've got to take care of business at home. And they start today probably as the slight favourites because of that home ground advantage. They must take advantage of it. So it should be a beauty. Can't wait for the opening bounce after this.
In my first couple of years, I sort of, it took me a while to adapt to the city.
looking back now, like, I was fairly homesick and just a bit lost, not around my family and the farm and that sort of area. Yeah, I'm loving my footy, especially at North Melbourne. Like, they've had shown great faith in me, and I'm just happy to start repaying them now. And I reckon we've still got a lot to prove and a lot to show.
And a milestone today. He was the best and fairest of the club last year. His 100th game. So he's right in his prime, Cunnington, 23 years of age, taken 5 in the draft in 2009. So it was tight, wasn't it? Have a look at that. Two votes between the top 5.
Would have been exciting at the end, Mac, in that particular count.
Absolutely. Let's go down to ground level. Jude Bolton's there, but so's Mark Soderstrom. Great to have you with us, Soders. And Soders, an unusual build-up for the Crows re the Adelaide Oval.
Bruce, you're right, absolutely. Now, what's actually happened is, of course, we had our World Cup cricket going on here for a long time. So the Crows actually didn't get an opportunity to set foot on the Adelaide Oval until yesterday morning. They had a 45-minute run following the cricket. This is what the Oval looked like on Thursday night when the Nitro Circus rolled into town. Motorbikes all over the deck. Now, security normally won't let anyone near the ground unless it's a match or training. So you can see there, real heart and mouth stuff for curator Damien Huff and his staff. So they spent all of Good Friday. There was no rest at all. They worked diligently to make sure the deck can be in pristine condition. It looks pretty good right now.
Good stuff, yeah. Fascinating, isn't it?
Great job.
A new era, eh, at Adelaide.
Let's go, Eddie. Toss the coin, mate. Let's go for it. Heads. Heads is the call. Tails it is. Good luck, guys.
So, Tex starts well, going to the left. So, a real new era for the Crows. A new CEO, a new coach, a new captain. Let's see what they can deliver this year against a team that has been pretty good.
Just looking at Phil Walsh, doesn't matter how many years you've... Now you're the man in charge. The buck stops with you. The responsibility's on your shoulders. It's a very different game of going to the footy than he has done in his career to this point.
Basil, what was his reputation like in Perth?
Fierce reputation, Bruce. Well organised. One of the best tactical brains in the game was his reputation.
And his effort to bring John Worsfold over to look at the club for a couple of days, a couple of weeks ago. How did that go down?
Yeah, did that at the last NAB Challenge match. It was a showdown. He analysed the structures in the coach's box, whether the message was getting through. Not so much the game plan, but how the communication was from Phil Walsh down to the players, down to his other coaches.
Well, that's the thing with game plans and tactics in the modern era. When you've got a senior coach and maybe 7 or 8 assistants, the communication between them is so critical so players don't get confused with the message.
Who's going to win, Lee?
I'm going to stick with the home team, just simply for that reason, the home team.
Basil?
Adelaide for me.
I think they'll win narrowly. It'll be a great game, I reckon.
Great way to start the new season, isn't it? In Adelaide, at the Adelaide Oval. So much expectation for both of these teams. Can North go one better than last year and make it into a grand final? Can Adelaide go back to the finals? Goldstein, Cunnington, he had the football, lost it. Eddie was ferocious there. Dangerfield, Eddie again. They've got the ball into Douglas's hands. Now Gibson mopping up at the back. Ferrito, you heard the call, touched. Hardigan just a little slow. Talia, Laird, Jentsch. Good, composed football. And they find Brown.
So out to Jacobs. Jacobs and Goldstein to be fascinating. Good kick by the big guy. Oh, he'll get a cheer, Van Berlo. So one captain maybe to the other. Well, Sloan might have been. So there you go. So Sloan within range. Just a moment ago, Lee. Tippett's picked up Walker. Tippett and Walker go hand in hand.
Fantastic running then by Jacobs. He actually charges out to the wing to be the release player for the Crows. That's the kind of running power you expect of a midfielder. So fantastic. Fantastic effort by him.
Not sure if there's a more popular player in town than this guy. Everybody loves Rory. He's a competitive beast. 45 metres out, tight angle. Struck it really well. That's the perfect start for the local team, the home side.
Yeah, always happy, both for him individually and for the Crows. You take the shot, he took the pressure. Not an easy set shot, but he made it. Great morale booster for him and the team.
So, terrific start, the Adelaide Crows. 2 minutes into the new season, they've got the first goal on the board. Again, Goldstein, very high. Dangerfield, busy again. Laird, off half-back, sends the ball towards half-forward, and Walker marks. The new skipper, he's a long way from home. He's eager to get going. He squeezes a low one, no mark. Thompson now, some mopping up to do. Wait, under pressure. Ball over the line. Good start, Adelaide lead.
Yes, no, they got the life and the energy in this first couple of minutes. Early days, of course, but they certainly, that little bit of that ascendancy early, just running that bit harder, winning the footy, winning the contest early.
See, a terrific mark from Dow Sando. In short.
Play on!
Bastinac. Interesting year last year, you're subbing all those finals. So wait, first real touch. Off a step. Goldstein, well done, Jacobs. Harvey front and centre. Led terrific. Talia's hands okay. Henderson loves to run and carry. That time he was hurled in. That's a good kick. That's a really good kick off the wrong side for him. To Cameron, squares it. So Walker getting involved early a couple of times. And then Tex on the march, decides to go to full forward. Good choice maybe. Eddie almost, he read it best bets, but he couldn't take the mark. And Bastinac gets it in the back pocket.
One of the teams, it's always hard sometimes, whether it's the Kangaroos have set up the spare back or the Crows. I'll count the numbers in a minute, but you can't kick it long and high into your forward 50 at the moment.
Goldstein, good mark. Gives it to Zeebel. Quick movement of the ball, and Thomas, terrific grab. Inside the centre square. Now, the best and fairest is breaking for him. He gets around one. Cunnington is still on. A very good kick, but he spilt the mark. Mark dropped it. Fired out Laird's way. Talia just enough on it. Squeezing it for Hardigan. They're going to get out of danger here. Smith taken over the line. Good pressure north, but the mark should have been taken.
Couple of early matchups, boys. Jack Zeeble's got danger field, and also Rory Laird's running really tight with Boomer Harvey.
Gee, that was unusual to see Cunnington drop that. Thomas had worked it so well.
Absolute shitter.
So Goldstein and Jacobs. Talk a lot about them today. Van Berlo, quick kick. Walker, so three.
It's been good.
He has. Hasn't used it brilliantly, I don't think, yet.
He's getting well upfield. You want him having shots for goal, but he's sort of getting the ball up into midfield release.
Van Berlo, danger field. Careful kick. And Jenkins, he had a subdued pre-season.
You won't believe he's pushing himself up just to exert an influence over this team as the new captain.
Yeah,
wants to get involved.
Yeah, I think so. When the ball's up the other end of the field, everybody's pushing up in the middle, of course, and so the modern key position forward is often going to get the ball up in the middle.
Jacobs and Goldstein, what a matchup this is, as Bruce mentioned. They've been at it stride for stride so far, and the footy's not coming out of there. Two really good ruckmen.
Well, in the last 4 years, either one of them has been rated the second best ruckman in the comp. They're both, over that journey, twice been in the All-Australian 40, the nominal list.
Jacobs flat a couple of seasons ago, much better last year, on the 40 again. Now Dal Santo, new dad. He boots the ball towards Petrie. Sun in the eye, maybe just for a fraction. Swallow there. Thomas, well done. Roved it well. Threw it onto the left. It's a high ball. Harvey can't get there. Had to wait for the bounce. The 229s, Laird and Harvey. Arriving now, Bastinac back to Harvey. Loves a goal. Not that time. First score of the season for North Melbourne. A behind off the boot of Boomer Harvey. Start of his 20th year. 385th game of football. If he plays 16 straight, he'll play his 400th against Brisbane at the Gabba.
Only two men have managed that so far, and we'll get two in the one season this year, seemingly, with Fletcher and Harvey. Remarkable stuff. Wells on the up. Missed though. Smith, Van Berlo. Dangerfield. To half forward. Getting back. Cameron so quick. Turned his man. McDonald with him. Well done, McDonald. Boundary throw and good contest. Notice Dangerfield lead.
Play attempting to get the ball.
Playing the wings, Dangerfield at the moment. Just to getting a little bit of outside ball, which I think is important for him.
Now, the ball's moving very quickly from end to end. No congestion around the footy, but when the ball's breaking into space, there's plenty of movement.
Well, then worked his way down in front. Gibson read it off hands. Ball towards half-back. Petrie caught at the back. Sloan, well done. As a free kick, advantage is allowed. Ball comes forward.
That's good.
Tex Walker.
That's good.
Wright's kick, Walker's mark, and the new skipper can go back and kick his first as Adelaide captain.
Go back what I said earlier on, Mac, midfield's a diamond dozen. The blokes who can stand under the footy and just win the contest in the air, worth their weight in gold. I mean, he really, you could say,
I don't think it's a 50-50 ball. He just was so strong. Gee, started well, Walker.
34 goals, 22 last season. The new skipper, his first decisive act as captain.
Well, this has been a really positive start, obviously.
And taking their chances. Two set shots, two goals. So they're making the most of their forward thrusts.
Van Bello's been good early. The captain's been terrific. Ellis Yeoman, Sloan, having an impact. Douglas, Laird, McKay. Douglas just not quite ready for it, but had time. So on the left boot, to half forward, it's all North Melbourne. Strong mark, time taken by Thompson. No Hanson today, no Grimer. I feel when they're all back there that Thompson can play probably a very attacking role that he loves to do. Kicks to half forward. At the back with Cheney. Cunnington. Pretty well weighed. Talia was... both players' eyes on the ball, but Talia getting the free kick. Wide to Brown. Smith, All-Australian last year, goes bang.
It's a long ball, well-directed ball. Fisted away from Lynch. Sloan read it well. Dangerfield, Jenkins coming through. Charlie Cameron onto the boot quickly, just offline. What's exciting play from Adelaide. They move the ball very quickly. Phil Walsh, first moments as a senior coach. And everybody pushed up into Adelaide's half of the ground. 2-2, North Melbourne just the one behind.
Pressing, aren't they? So expecting that. Goldstein, Talia. Strong mark by Goldstein. Whirls. Interrupted season last year. Cunnington. Waite tucked it under the arm. This has been terrific. Harvey within range, but he'll go wide. Sets up Higgins. First look at him now. It's a good kick, Higgins. Kicks it. That's a terrific goal. A team goal, one into the other.
The ball through. As soon as you get over the top here, you've got to play the ball on quickly. This is what the Kangaroos do really well. They win the ball, now they play it on. And now the Crows' defence are all in between. And now it's a matter they then held position really well and kick the goal, the Kangaroos.
Not a bad first touch in there for your new club. First kick, first goal.
Yep.
Yeah, it's a good feeling, that's for sure. Ball loose now. Douglas running hard off half-back. That was good work, the Crows combining. And the long ball down to Walker again. Douglas led. And the kick onto the chest.
Right on the chest. Just inside. Tell us, line clear out, guys. Both be out.
So, how's this for a start then? Couple of shots at goal. One set shot. No problem. This for his second goal.
Wind's going slightly with this kick.
Been a bright start. Kick has the distance. Just drifted across and a behind for Walker.
North have to get some more pressure around the footy because it's just coming in so fast. Taylor Walker's already taken five marks, so he's going at record pace at the moment.
He's going to set some new figures for himself if he can keep that up today. Early days, yeah. Bastinac off a step. Dangerous kick, Sloan courageously. Douglas inboard. Led, and that's a poor kick. We really missed the lot.
Come back, five, Paddy. Keep coming.
It's a really good exhibition of the game this first 10 minutes. The ball is flowing up and back. Good skills from both teams. Great exhibition.
Yeah, good courage from both sides as well. So high ball, Jenkins now. Ellis Yeoman, he was slow, had plenty of time. Has to be holding the ball. Attlee got him. So we're... not in much doubt this year, are we, Lee? If you take them on.
Yep. Oh, yeah, no, it was a Fedingham holding the ball, took them on, got pinged.
He's going to be holding the ball every time. Good grab by Petrie. So slowish start from Big Drew. Long ball now. Goes for home. Wait. Hardigan right there with him. Runners arrive. Higgins has kicked one already. How about this for a start? Number two.
Cooney and Higgins, eh? Cooney yesterday, ex-doggies, eh? found the goals all right, haven't they?
Well, both sides are moving the ball really quickly through the middle of the ground, which I love footy like that. I hate it when players just, they get the ball in the middle of the ground and they're just scared to go for it. Both sides are backing themselves to play on, move the ball quickly, and therefore they've both been able to generate a couple of shots at goal from from a handful of entries. Entries are 9-4 in the Adelaide's favour, but they've been able to break through, run hard through the middle of the ground, the Kangaroos, and Higgins has finished off twice.
Gee, what a dream start for him. Sean Higgins, high draft pick, taken from the Dogs, for the Dogs, and had an interrupted career there, lots of hamstring problems. Terrific start, two kicks, two goals. Van Berlo, whirls. A couple of bad errors from the Crows in the last couple of minutes. Laird missed an easy shot. Ellis Yeoman seemed to freeze inside the forward 50. And they may be paying for it here. North on a bit of a burst. Caught underneath Zeebel. Hit the ground hard with him, Cheney, and a boundary throw in. So a good start for Adelaide. Not counting for much on the scoreboard right now.
So Crows by 2 points. And North Melbourne inside their forward 50. It's been a cracking start, just what you'd expect. Round one, two sides pretty evenly matched. Higgins again got his little kick away, taken by Smith, the All-Australian. Bouncing ball towards Lynch, who took it cleanly. Ellis Yeoman did well, got out of the McMillan tackle. Goes forward, the skipper's on again. Yet another mark, that's six now. Tex Walker, now Ellis Yeoman's kept going. Jenkins is the long option. He's going to come shorter instead, and Van Berlo. So current skipper to former skipper,
who also is getting a fair bit of the ball. We've talked a lot about Tex, so Nathan Van Berlo. Bright start by him. Kicks to a two-on-one against him. Ferrito tried to take the mark, couldn't quite swallow. McDonald played more games than any other first-year player last season. Out wide and a boundary throw-in. 23 games he played last year. No goals. He had a terrific season. Morgan North have done pretty well here. Into maybe a slight breeze. Adelaide with a lot of emotion early. A couple of early goals. And North correcting it.
So Petrie now doing the ruck work. Jacobs with him. Ellis Yeoman starting to get his hands on the footy. Just again a little slow. Cunnington taking to the ground. Gibson bursting out of the pack. Good football now. They work the ball through the middle. Zeebel got it nicely from Attlee. Sends an awkward-looking ball inside 50. So Hardigan needs to be clean here. Good handball to Jentsch. Kick pulls it around McDonald. That was very clever. Finds McKay.
It was a clever kick. That Jentsch, that's his trademark, really. Skillful, thinking player. So Dangerfield getting a lot of wide footy. As we said early, he's had enough of it early. He hasn't really penetrated yet, though.
Move it on. Play on.
If you had two of them, Lee, I'd play one of them at half-back. I reckon he'd just troll the game from there.
He could play anywhere, couldn't he, really?
He reads it.
Maybe not ruck, but in the other position, he's got some chance of playing.
Deep forward, mid, cross half-back. Decides to stay out there. He was on his way off and turned around. Jacobs, Petrie, Jacobs easily. That's a great tackle. What a tackle from Wells on Sloan Cunnington. Jacobs, who came into the game for Brown pre-match. And whirled by Jentsch at the back. So North pushing hard here.
Talia got it from Jentsch. Low, flat one. Good mark taken by Cheney.
2 metres. Back another metre. Back a metre.
So Cheney's first game for his new club. 41 games at Melbourne and Hawthorn. As we mentioned at the top, 9 games last year in a premiership season for the Hawks, but didn't figure when it really counted. Jacobs, good grab, hits the ground running. He's full of confidence, the big man. Kick, well, just waiting a little bit was Douglas. Could have done better there. Interesting, this one now. They've got him from front and back, and it's holding the ball.
As soon as you dive on it, and as long as you don't get fell on the back, on the head, that's if you don't get it clear and play... Players are holding it in because they know you've already dived on it. Yep. Automatic free kick.
Jacob's kick wasn't terrific, but he should have marked that one.
Yeah. See, that is a good mark by Smith. And somebody's down.
Wait.
It's Brown, I think, but he's okay.
I don't know if he's injured or not, so I don't want to be dangerous. That's it.
I don't know if you know. I'm sure you did, Baz, when you're doing these two teams. A lot of blokes with the same surnames on either team, but Brown's late withdrawal takes that one away. That's a poor... effort by Lynch. He really should have gobbled that up. Thomas, at least quick, but he's caught by Van Berlo and then slung. McKay couldn't take hold of it. Cunnington well done. Thomas, high tackle.
Test the tackler, Thomas. You always buckle the knees as the tackle comes. So if the tackle is a little high, it'll slip right up above the shoulder.
So just an untidy minute for Douglas.
Couple of errors there. High ball now inside 50. Wells came with a big flight. She thrown out by Sloan. It appeared to be high ball now. Coming back inside. Attlee's kick. No clean mark. Chance on the ground for Gibson. He swings it back. Well done, Goldstein. Important hand in there. Still alive for the Adelaide Crows. Bit indecisive. Well done, Hardikin. Found the footy on the ground. Across to McKay. And now out of side. Long kick. It's a good kick and Sloan should be away.
He is a good kick, McKay. And that was important. Sloan down the line. So how many marks for Walker, Bass?
Seventh mark for Walker.
Seven. So on that left foot, that's a good kick. Douglas in a beautiful spot now. Can Zeeble get him? The bounce of the ball, not great for Douglas. Hooks it back and finds Jenkins. End-to-end footy for the Crows. Walker, such a catalyst in this opening term. He's just presenting, Lee, isn't he?
Yeah, presenting so well. I mean, that, again, it's the transition when he got these, had the one couple of shots at goal, but mostly he's been actually just when they're coming off half back, you need someone making the run into space. And Walker's working really hard.
His seven marks have been more than he's had in his previous nine games.
Gee, good stuff, Jude. So Jenkins, 40 goals last year from 20 matches. That was a good return. He's got it. He gets his first and Adelaide's third. Hey guys, I've had a busy weekend, but during the week I'm going to go to Presto and I'm going to watch my favourite movie. Lee, nothing to do with you or me. No Country for Old Men. It was a beauty, I can tell you.
Well, good timing, Bruce. The free 30-day trial is on right now, so why not see Bruce's favourite movie? Sloan. Here's Eddie. Got his hands on the footy. That was good movement of the ball. Slick. Well done, Thompson, mopping up Goldstein. Left behind by McDonald. Jacobs there. Ellis Yolman pushed forward. We'll get a free.
Bring it back, Lex. Straight up, Lex.
So Ellis Yolman just finding the tempo of the game now. His second game from Flinders Park here in SA originally. He's been on the list for a long time. Holding Walker. Free kick.
Marked it anyway. Geez, a target.
Well, Lee, they got a mismatch because Thompson was on the mark, and I think it was right. There was it right against?
Yeah, sometimes that shouldn't happen, really. It's just really sloppy. The guy on the mark stands the mark rather than actually sticking with his direct opponent. So, but he's looking a bit big and strong for any of those Kangaroos defenders at this point of the game.
Well, it would have been mark number eight. It can be goal number two. We're right behind it, and the skipper hits the post.
There's enough time, though, Lee, then to slide someone back in front of him and close up the dangerous space.
So I just wonder if Adelaide have got value for money here, Lee. I mean, it's just a nine-point game.
No, well, they haven't seven scoring shots to three, but they've missed their two or three very gettable ones, which leaves it only the nine-point margin.
So neat Dow Sando, isn't he? Big fly at the back from Lynch. Smith, normally a long kick, we know that. That is a goal. There you go, off one step. That is a weapon when you can do that.
Here we go.
He's had six disposals and 100% efficiency.
It's one kick, but it's instinctive, makes terrific contact. Didn't have a chance to think about it. A lot of times the thinking part of it paralyses players when they have a shot, but he just instinctively one step bang.
So Adelaide out to a 15-point lead now, 4.5, a little under to play. And you get the feeling now, Lee, that they've got the lead that they probably should have.
No, I think the 15-point lead is a reasonable result for the way the game's been played.
Nick Del Santo out there fighting hard for the footy. North Melbourne officials tell us he had his first good night's sleep. He became a father for the first time just a few weeks ago with partner Jules. And it's another baby Jude. Baby Jude, congratulations to the Del Santo. Smith kicked the last goal. Cunnington right there with him. Ellis Yolman fighting hard. Here's Nicky D. Well done. So clean, as Bruce said, and we saw a great example of it there. Gibson's kicked forward. Well done by Cheney. He's fitted in really well. That'll be 50. Just watching some of their NAB footy, Lee. He looks a really good fit for the Adelaide defence.
Yeah, well, he's probably going to play. They've already got Tali, who's a top-notch key defender, so Tuney becomes that second or third. He looks like he's got the weight matchup as much as anything at this point of the game.
Interesting too, no Brown and no Black for North Melbourne. Weight, the preferred option. And dropping in and taking a good grab. Gibson there got into the space.
That's what Jude was talking about before. Being aware they're probably going to go to Walker. Make sure you get an extra player across to block the space.
Strong mark by Cunnington. He dropped a sitter earlier in this term, but a beauty there. Best and fairest, as we said, from last season, playing his 100th. Weight. Higgins has made a spectacular start with a couple of goals, with a couple of kicks. Weight, okay. Kicks to a hot spot. Bastanac quickly to fall forward in a good spot for North here. Well done by Wright there for the Crows against the flow. Laird banging it hard out to halfback. Waite was the first contestant. And then Bastanac on hands and knees. Now in trouble and gone. Holding the footy.
Pinged by umpire Lee Fisher. Umpires today, Fisher, Nichols and Mollison. So that's his view down the ground for Smith. Beautiful day at a glorious place to play football. And, well, cricket as well. Just a beautiful multi-purpose stadium. Even the Nitro funny cars.
They did an outstanding job of just replacing the centre pitch in a few days. And you wouldn't even know there was one there.
MCG Thursday night.
Yeah, unbelievable.
Sloan's kick, not a good one. So Zeebel read that well. Now a chance. Bastanac. Can they catch them on the hop here, North Melbourne? Here's Waite from long range. Kick, not ideal. It favoured the wrong man at Brown. Read it well. Wrapped it up. Not a good kick in then from Jared Waite.
Wasted a chance at the turnover coming in the centre of the ground. So North with a real opportunity there. Gibson pushed in the back. Jacobs got a high one.
Thanks, Drew. So, right there. Stay up, Brett.
Good kick by Jacobs. Cameron, can he turn his man? No. Cunnington's handball, just a little too fierce. Smith's been outstanding. Wright getting deep. Lynch. Adelaide's foot skills generally have been very good. Working hard, the big fella, Sauce. And then Sauce lumbers to fall forward. Where's Tex? It's Dangerfield, not quite. Betts roving it. He'll kick a goal. Nothing would be surer than that. Eddie rams it home. They've got some potency, haven't they, when they're all up and running. There's a really good look about this forward 50 look for Adelaide, I reckon. Just a bit of a bash and crash. And
Sam Jacobs around the middle.
Yeah.
Was important too. I think he's just done a bit better than Goldstein in the movement part of the ruck work in this first part of the game. He's been the link player around the middle of the ground as he was then.
And the beauty of the long kick, Lee. It came in hard. It came in long. And it caught the defenders out. Dangerfield's big fly was important as
well.
Not sure
you whether to drop it on Eddie Betts' head, I've got to say, Basil. The long kick in, but certainly he recovered quickly.
So Goldstein this time down to Zeebel. Ellis Yeoman got him high this time. Zeebel, 5 goals last time these two sides played. It was down in Hobart, round 22 last year. It was not quite an elimination final. It was almost a qualifying final. Van Berlo, beautiful kick. Eddie, who kicked the last one. Now Dangerfield running in support. Uses Patrick Dangerfield now. He goes with a long ball. Caught in front. Good mark, Lynch.
Just now played McMillan. McMillan has the problem with the defender. He's half looking at his opponent. He's half looking at the footy. And that enabled Lynch to just basically step around because he's actually watching the ball in the air. Defenders have to be able to play the ball on its merits. Too conscious of their opponents, quite often they get caught out of position as he did then.
Well, this for a 27-point lead on the quarter-time siren.
Yeah, not with me, Jamie.
How massive this would be. What an emphatic start it's been by the Adelaide Crows. Lynch for that lead on the siren. Couldn't get much better, could it, for a rookie coach? What a start to the coaching caper for the new man in charge.
Absolutely. So the Crows fly away early. It's 40-13 here on a Sunday afternoon at the Adelaide Oval. Terrific start by the Crows. Walker, phenomenal. 8 marks in the opening term. Kicked a goal. Missed a couple, actually, but he led from the front. So a great first game, or first quarter of his first game as the Crows captain. Adelaide really hammering the advantage home late in the quarter. 6-4 to 2-1. Yes, unbelievable entertainment with Presto. So go to your 30-day free trial now for your favourite TV shows or movies. Let's go down to Jude Bolton, and he's with Brad Scott.
Brad, not an ideal start. You just couldn't seem to slow their ball movement.
No, I don't think ball movement's the issue. I mean, we just, you know, we didn't capitalise from our opportunities going forward, and they had the ball going forward on their terms a bit more. So, you know, defensively, it was really disappointing, more in our back half than around the contest.
In particular, those marks by Taylor Walker needed some more support in front.
Yeah, and that was disappointing because it's something that we were well aware of, so we didn't execute it very well. We've got to turn that around.
Thanks for your time, mate. So, it is, how have you viewed this quarter from the Crows?
Well, Jude, when Phil Walsh got the job, the one area he wanted to concentrate most on was the defensive actions of the Crows. And, in fact, he wanted manic defensive pressure from those players, highlighted magnificently just late in that first quarter there. We saw Rory Laird one-on-one with Boomer Harvey. He won the contest there, goes down, ends up with Tom Lynch. He puts it through the Crows, get that 27-point buffer.
Good on your sodas. So, second term about to get underway. Adelaide by 27 points. Last year, they were third for scoring. We know they can kick a score. They were 10th defensively. And the wise heads talk about having to be top five in both to really challenge for a premiership. So no secret that defensively, Adelaide will want to improve.
They moved the ball quickly. 61 kicks, 35 handballs. So they kicked the footy, so they got the ball moving quickly. 80% efficiency, which is really high with their disposal.
Of course, we know North have been good against the top six teams last season, but they dropped games around about teams close to them, and this is where they've got to improve. And Adelaide is one of the teams that they would expect to beat if they can really challenge and go further. Goldstein, Swallow had it, lost it. Wells, ditto. Goldstein went in again. Eddie Betts tackling him. Swallow there, hard at it. Dangerfield too. It'll come up again. So he didn't look happy at all, Brad Scott, nor should he be, really. 27 points, opening quarter, long time to get ready for this. And that wasn't what he wanted.
Notice Betts has started both terms in the centre square, right up the middle. Jenkins, Douglas, wide. Well, that's 9 marks for Walker. He's into the breeze slightly. Could probably get the trip here, I reckon.
There's the big grandstand that he's kicking towards, which it really, any breeze that's coming from that direction, it should block it out pretty much completely.
You love it when they do this, I reckon. Take responsibility.
Oh, yeah.
As long as when they kick it, it's fantastic. Let's see how he goes. It's coming back. It's a good kick. There, don't you love it? Oh, how big is Texas right now?
Look at this. He knows he can kick 60 metres, but you've still got to time it correctly. He made beautiful contact. That's taking the pressure and delivering.
Goal number 199 for his career, and 5 in a row. The last 5 goals of the game for the Adelaide Crows, and Douglas to Dangerfield. Here they come again. Jenkins maybe just caught off hop there. Thompson dropped what he should have taken. Gee, pressure let off there.
I reckon Phil Walsh at the moment thinking, pretty good decision to make, Taylor Walker, Tex Walker, captain. He's killing them.
It's an interesting... How big a surprise was it, Bruce, when he was made Adelaide captain?
I'll get to that in a moment. Sloan to Betts. I have got a story there, Baz. Betts to fall forward. Here he is again.
I think the answer was outside Adelaide, or outside the Crows, you're a bit surprised that Dangerfield didn't become captain, but...
He's about to kick his 200th career goal. Very quickly, I had dinner with Brenton Sanderson about 2 weeks before he got sick. Yeah. He thought that this was the natural leader of the club.
He's the natural leader.
I think
leader.
Brendan Sanderson was going to make the same call.
Well, that's what you
when
know.
You walk into
internally.
The club rooms at Adelaide, you walk into the club rooms, this is the bloke that everybody gravitates towards, and he's kicked a behind. So two goals, three so far today. But so a slight surprise, I think, but...
You should never second-guess clubs about who should be captain, because you've got to be internal, know the players, know the personalities, know the characters, and then they make, obviously, the best informed decision.
Well, you mentioned that time that John Worsfold spent here a few weeks ago. He thought he wouldn't be the man, obviously, walking from the outside. He said within 72 hours at the club, he could understand perfectly why Tex Walker was the captain. It's been a ferocious start, hasn't it? Adelaide by 34 points. Just repeating, they've kicked the last five goals of the game. Forward again. Walker spilt another one. That one easier. Eddie Betts has kicked a goal. He squeezes it short. Van Berlo, not quite. Swallow on top of him. They're under all sorts of pressure, North Melbourne. Bastinac, McDonald, he just thumping the ball out of the danger zone. Over the football now. Cheney, he did very well against Waite. Jacobs, back to Cheney, inside Thomas, and then the ball spills over the line.
This forward press for Adelaide's interestingly, isn't it? North are going, they're forward press for Adelaide. North are having real trouble bringing you out here.
Yeah, no, they're pushing up. They got through on that, one of Higgins's goals from the kick-in, but Adelaide are locking it in beautifully at the moment.
Jacobs and Goldstein. Van Berlo had more time probably. Goes bang to full forward. Walker working with Tippett. Dangerfield's in a good spot. Now a better spot.
Beautiful.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Eddie gets his second.
Have a look at Dangerfield's movement. It's more the brain's work. He said, oh, that's too hard a shot. I won't do that one. I'll break the tackle. Eddie's going into the goal square. That is just composure under pressure, which is what we love about the best players in our game.
11 disposals for Dangerfield, 10 for Walker. They lead all of them out there on the ground. Touch ball towards Eddie, heard the call. Thompson got it across to Swallow. Harvey, a little fumble as well. Van Berlo was right there with him. Now Bastinac. It's a rare trip forward for North Melbourne in this quarter. And Attlee has the footy on the wing. Jacobs breaking for him. He ignores that one. Adelaide's defence, it is manic at the moment. High ball. Again, Cheney's done well. Douglas, good work, McKay. Handball through, Ellis Yolman. And now Van Berlo. A high ball. Dangerfield, the target again. Good use of the body, no.
The umpire paid it as he saw it. And it was probably in the back, I guess, but could have easy been. Was that all?
Push out.
What's interesting,
yeah, it was a push out.
Umpire a long way away that paid the, not the umpire closest.
Yeah, we might have a look at that one at half time just to see how that looked from a second go.
Jacobs beating Goldstein for the moment as Adelaide are beating North to full forward. Dangerfield again. Basil mentioned the 11 disposal. Eight kicks is probably even more important.
Yeah, there's no doubt. They're kicking the ball, Adelaide. They're not messing around with the hand pass. That's probably because the North Melbourne pressure just isn't anywhere near. It's only been 15 tackles apiece. So players are running around of congestion. It's a matter of who can win it and use it best. And clearly, the Crows are well up in all those capacities.
Well, Adelaide's kicked the last six goals in this match. Make that seven. Dangerfield having a huge impact.
This free kick, maybe pushed him in the back. Sometimes it's just better, more body strength. I would call that play on if you had the benefit of the replay.
He was on his feet too, so who knows what may have been. Didn't matter in the end. He marked the next one in. Five disposals this quarter for Dangerfield. Three score involvements. Eddie Betts, he's away. He gets to the 50, pulls the kick, and the skipper marks, this time for number 200. This will be his 11th disposal, and it is his 10th mark. They are incredible numbers, Lee.
They're one another centre back. Well, he just keeps getting on the end of it. The 10 marks, only one of them's contested, so they've been moving marks where he's actually been moving to space.
Two goals, three. Make it two goals, four. So, really, it should be a much better day already. There's been some kickable ones in there. Adelaide's lead, quite incredible. 47 points. And that's what they're looking up at up in front of them.
So, North just need to get hold of the footy. We've got to quieten Adelaide down here. Smith, clever. Cameron. So Charlie Cameron to full forward, Dangerfield getting back with McMillan and a boundary throw-in. He's a hard matchup, Dangerfield, isn't he?
Well, he is. The hard matchups all over the field for the Crows. Their speed away from the contest is really impressive, but I think as unimpressive is the Kangaroos' ability to actually lock the ball in or to chase hard when the Crows break from the congestion.
Goldstein bets red at best, though. Cunnington. Cunnington squeezing, slow, not quite. McMillan well played. Goldstein to Thomas. To Dow Sander. They need some poise somewhere. Cheney. Real journeyman, isn't he? To right. Yench. Wright will be pleased because it was a turnover. Cunnington. Thomas runs into a brick wall, but he did well. Hands and knees. Zeeble, Sloan, got him. Henderson. It was a throw from Zeeble, and that was a terrific tackle from Sloan.
Oh, ferocious stuff. Ferocious. 47 points then. So Sloan, he goes long. Eddie at the back. Three North Melbourne players up in front. Worked out okay. Swallow, right. Now Thompson, Del Santo, Goldstein. They've worked it okay here. Pushed off the ball, Higgins, right, into trouble, Petrie, they got it to Zeeble, they've done it okay actually, now Attlee needs it to sit, it did sit, Douglas chasing, Attlee takes him on, this is good stuff North, the short kick at the feet, didn't need to be there for Bastanac, McKay got the ball across, Douglas a little slow, still alive for Laird, mopping up, Ellis Yolman in there, Harvey gets the footy, works it backwards, here they come again.
Jacobs the full forward, good looking strong kick, Hardigan there, contest with Wade.
Simultaneous mark.
It was fascinating how North brought the ball out a moment ago against the press. We needed about eight or nine handballs. They did it so well. Just couldn't make it stick in the air. McKay, terrific. To Sloan. Off a step. Walker turned his man. Lynch. Cameo role from him so far. Twisting, turning, getting out of trouble. Good looking kick off the boot. Puts it into a dangerous spot. North may be able to cut it off. McMillan's had a tough day so far. Kicks to centre forward, a good one. Zeeble, well done by Laird. Free kick.
Smith here. Lindsay. Tom, that one.
So 20 minutes ago, the margin was 2 points. Crows lead by 47 right now.
Is Laird. Liked his game this afternoon. He's done everything that he's needed to do well. Tarley up, and they're away again. Sloan bouncing, chasing his Bastanac. He goes for home. It was an awkward kick off the boot. Now, Walker right there with Tippett. And over the line. And the boundary line gives North a bit of a breather. It's been coming thick and fast in their direction.
It's been a wave, hasn't it? Like a tsunami. Jenkins used the body on Petrie. Cunnington, Swallow. Zeeble hammers it away with a torpedo now. Wells and Talia, the bounce important. Hardigan read it okay. Wake gets into his back slightly. Talia on the up to Brown. And then Brown off a step. Long and hard. Walker waits this time for the bounce. Can he turn Tippett inside out? He stayed with Tippett all the way, Brad Scott. Walker on the left. He's a beautiful left foot kick, a bit like Tredray was. So no move Tippett with Walker. I guess there's no other matchup.
Yeah, when your big fella turns onto his left foot and drills a pass, he's a very skilled player.
Tredra used to do that. I mean, he was better on the left than he was on the right. Kick.
Well, the two goals four has probably made it not look as bad as what it could have been. 11 disposals for Walker. Petrie up in front, won that one. Knocked off it, though. Douglas takes the footy. Long ball inside right, camped under it. Good mark. Never easy. Got close to the man on the mark. They want to move it quickly to try and beat the press. Henderson got high. Well done, Attlee at the back. Swallow. Now they're away through Thomas. Handball didn't quite get to where it needed to go. Higgins recovered well. Swallow back to Higgins. Good chase from behind. Brown got him. Great pressure, Adelaide.
14 of the last 16 inside 50s for the Crows. Basil mentioned the word pressure, and that's what they're applying. It's...
Yeah, the pressure of actually winning the footy, Macca, but then when the Kangaroos get the footy, their pressure is just as intense to win it back.
Talia. There's going to be a lot of football intelligentsia watching this match and Phil Walsh's first effort as a coach. Yeah. Just seeing what sort of a blueprint he's brought to the Crows in the pre-season. I spoke to a club captain yesterday at a... waiting to come home from the championships. He told me that Adelaide had the best pre-season of any club. He doesn't obviously play for them, but I found it intriguing that he would tell me that.
How did he know, Bruce?
Douglas, to fall forward. He might be a better judge than most of us at the moment. I'll get his tips for the championships tomorrow.
Yes,
he's
right.
Behind.
Yeah, looking pretty good at the moment in terms of... I mean, we know that really the last quarter of round one, you've never seen players looking so tired, but Adelaide just building the lead before the extreme fatigue sets in for both teams.
So Ferrito kicks to himself, hardly called his name all afternoon. Good mark in front. That's terrific by Smith. What a player is the All-Australian. He kicked into Bastinac. McDonald ran into pressure. Now look at the Adelaide players go to work. This is where they have been. Quite superb. They've given away a free kick, though, here.
Adelaide are also running at 81% efficiency by foot and hand. They're just dominating the game at the moment.
What are you seeing, Jude? I mean, you're right down there. What are you seeing that's different about them?
Oh, you can feel that forward press. Their pressure has been enormous. It feels like the way Port Adelaide dominated Richmond here during the finals.
It's a good analogy, actually, Lee. Yep, we were here that day, weren't we?
No, that's true. That's the way the game has been played at this point. They've been winning the contest, bursting clear from the congestion and just pinning the Kangaroos on most occasions when they actually do rarely get the ball in hand.
That was bad luck for Wright. He stuck the boot out and somehow off the boot and out of bounds on the full. Goldstein at the back. Big flight. Didn't quite mark Harvey on the forward handball. Came out from Higgins. And now the counter-attack is on Van Berlow. Well done, Wells. Got him.
Pushing back.
Well, maybe a bit unlucky. Wasn't the full push, but enough according to the umpire. Jentsch has missed the mark. Higgins, Harvey. Now, there's not much in front. He pulls up and goes the short one to Petrie. And I think right now they'd be thankful to have a shot on goal. Petrie quickly, they're outnumbered here. At the back, Harvey, not a great kick. He got Brown high.
And important in that, it looks like the Kangaroos were flowing forward, but the Adelaide got more numbers into their back 50 to protect that Petrie kick.
Just with Petrie there,
worked
it's
hard.
Easy for me, but I wish he'd done what Walker did a moment ago and take it on. He could have kicked it from there.
Try and kick the long shot.
Well, he had the breeze behind him. I think he could have scored from there. They just need a goal and then another one after that. They need to hit the scoreboard. 16 scoring shots to 3. Is a true reflection on what we're seeing. Awful kick, that one. But a good bounce, maybe, for the Crows. Thompson. And that'll be a ball up. I reckon the holding the ball, what I've seen this first weekend, the adjudication's been good.
I don't think it's a whole lot different. The rule hasn't changed. All the umpires are doing is saying, well, if you've had prior opportunity, we're going to ping you for holding the ball. But frankly, that was the rule last year anyway.
Yeah, but that was the grey area, Lee, because some umpires or some circumstances, they'd let it go on long.
What you're saying is everybody's umpiring at the same, Basil. Let's say that in 2 months' time.
Well, halfway through first round, it does look a bit cleaner, doesn't it? Swallow, that's a throw.
Great job.
It wasn't called. And now over the footy, Brown. Comes out, McKay, hard at it. North Melbourne just desperate to try and tie it up. Dangerfield, brilliant. Charlie Cameron with a pace. And you go again here. Just couldn't get it cleanly second time. McDonald did well. Over the footy, Higgins, Dangerfield, Douglas. Good tackle, Goldstein. Got the footy, got the man and took him to ground.
Sorry, mate.
The big ruckman just tried to lift his team.
Dangerfield's ability to keep his feet there was really impressive a moment ago. Henderson off a step. She's got onto that to fall forward. North with the numbers. Jenkins, Ferrito and McMillan. So that avalanche for Adelaide's dried up a little, but they keep on pressing here. North have been able to do nothing at the other end. Brad Scott was stirred at quarter time. He's not going to be happy right now. It'll be an interesting North Melbourne room at the heart. Hey, Jude, it was obvious.
Yep.
When you're talking to Scotty at quarter time, he was fuming.
Yeah, I felt like Mark Stevens talking to Mick Malthouse a little bit, mate.
Yes, Brad knows as a coach you've always just got to work out the method. What can you do? What kind of plan can you sell to your team to turn around what is just a really bad first half? Not act like a fan who's angry. That's the challenge all coaches have in this kind of circumstance.
Easy to do?
Very hard to do.
How about that? The last 10 scores in this game, Adelaide's way. Only one player for North Melbourne in double figures disposal-wise. That's Cunnington with 12. There are seven for the Adelaide Crows. That's a high ball in. And out of bounds on the full.
Thanks, Taylor. Back here.
Douglas.
Your kick.
So.
I'm just thinking, Basil, if the holding the ball real doesn't come contentious, make the game a bit boring, wouldn't it? That's what it must.
We'll find something else. We'll find something else.
It'll always be contentious, always was, always will.
Here's Joel Tippett playing game number 5 today into Lynch. That was awkward and in many ways sums up North Melbourne's first half. The pressure has been ferocious, nothing obvious to go to, and it forces the error. Close to half-time, Adelaide by 49 points.
Jacobs and Goldstein again. Jacobs lays it down. Betts held up, and then no in the back. Ellis Shulman, Betts gets a little topo. Douglas held on to. Ball not quite there. Jenkins, it's like a rugby scrum. Someone's kicked it out of the air and forced over for a behind. Betts stiff there. He was held up on the burst from the stoppage. 9-9 to 2-1.
That's a thrashing in anyone's language, isn't it? 18 scoring shots to 2, to 3.
Yeah. North has not scored at all in this term. We saw a bit of that yesterday, didn't we? Scoreless quarter, but this is second quarter, not the last.
Very different conditions, I think, we're playing in. I mean, this is a really free-flowing game, being totally dominated by the Crows.
A half century at the Adelaide Oval. And it's the Crows' lead with still 5.5 minutes to play in this term. Swallow could be even further, and it may well be now. Right, running through the middle again, the pressure. Henderson, the tackle didn't really stick. Could have been cleaner. Gibson, Lynch, McMillan got him from behind. Swallow in front, and up it will come again.
The start of the game is always who can take the congestions away, the ball away from these stoppages. And I think it's 11-3 Adelaide's way this quarter, so that's where the Kangaroos have to start trying to turn the game around.
And Swallow.
No secret in that, so not so hard to do.
And if you look at the Kangaroos, they've got great clearance players. Swallow,
yeah,
Cunningham, they have, Zeeble.
But they're being dominated today. Yeah, dominated today.
Never forget that match where Swallow absolutely slaughtered Adelaide, and Eddie had himself in that opening term.
Play on.
He had career high that day, and his clearance total was phenomenal, but not today. Cheney, maybe manhandle. Higgins gets it to Cunnington. Well-weighted handball to Harvey, to Zeeble. And then Zeeble, clever-looking kick, though. The percentages were always a bit low. Yench, clever. Sauce, well done. It's been a terrific pickup, hasn't he, Jacobs? Henderson. They just know if Jacobs is fit, that's their ruckman. They can work around him.
He's big and he's strong. He's running hard today to be a link player as well as just his ruck work.
Henderson, Sloan just on the ground. He flew for that mark. Eddie Betts couldn't quite get it cleanly. Sloan, well done. Van Berlo. Jacobs got an important hand in there. Dangerfield. Ellis Yolman got better as the game's gone on. Terrific kick. Now, who was it intended for? That man. Get out of the way. The skipper's coming through. Short one to Lynch. Good footy.
Michael, 1 metre. Michael, back a metre. One. Yep, that's it. I said 1 metre.
He's a beautiful kick at the football, Walker. Tony Lockett, they always say, was a fantastic pass for the ball, but mostly in the game, all he had is shots for goal. But Walker's just a key position player. Jonathan Brown was like that. They're just beautiful
kicks to two, mates, as well as kicks for goal.
Tom Lynch, one of only five current day players who have kicked 10 or more in a game.
In fact,
goes today, short instead.
In fact, kicking for goal today is what Taylor Walker hasn't been good at. Two goals, four from his six shots to this point.
Another metre out. No, this was clever. And I suppose North Melbourne could be forgiven for thinking the lead wouldn't come, but it did. They've kicked the last seven goals of the game. This for eight, and goal number 200. The captain leading from the front.
Well, you... Hollywood wouldn't write a script like it, would you? Captain for the first time, 12 marks in the opening half, seven shots on goal.
Well, at 24 years of age, he's only just reaching his prime.
Well, his 12 marks are more than anyone's taken in this entire round at the moment.
It'll be fascinating to see at the end of the year where he sits in the elite forwards.
Yep. Coming out this way.
I mean, can he get himself into that sort of stratosphere and be an All-Australian? Well, he's certainly made a mark today. Dangerfield's been superb. He's had a lot of mates. Bouncing ball, Jacobs didn't do well. Cameron's quick, he's got Betts outside. And then Cameron decides to go himself and sprays it a bit. And it's a behind.
Well, he was in that ballpark until he hurt his knee, of course.
63 goals in that year,
So last year was very much a recovery from the knee injury. So he looks absolutely primed, doesn't he?
57 points for Rito. Kicks to himself. They could be 10 goals in front, Adelaide, at half-time. I don't think anybody in their wildest dreams, any of the Adelaide supporters, full of faith and confidence and hope for the new season, could have imagined that. Walker! Not quite. Jenkins on the ground, gives it to Eddie. That's his third. Adelaide have kicked 9 in a row, and they do lead by 10 goals.
You always say if your ball comes long and high in your full line, someone has to launch themselves at the footy just to make sure there's not a big, effective, offensive punch away. So Walker was the one who filled that role.
Last nine goals of the game is one story. 21 scoring shots to three is the other, Bruce.
Dangerfield to Sloan to kick the opening goal of the match. A second running bounce. No one coming to him. Decides to load up. Walker, goal! He's kicked another one, Sloan. Amazing stuff. Adelaide, 10 goals in the last 10 of the match they've kicked. Well, they wanted it. That's the other story today. They wanted to build a fortress here last year. They didn't manage it. They've had a good start.
Well, they've got the foundations, Bruce. I think it's fair to say that this is a pretty good start to their 2015 King. Pretty good's an understatement. They've just been outstanding.
Can you hear that noise, Lee? That's the alarm bells ringing around the competition.
And Lee, it does remind me of the quality of Port Adelaide late last year here.
Yep. Just really offensive, free-flowing. High-scoring footy. It's not just shutting the Kangaroos down. It's actually kicking 12 goals and a half of footy. That's great going.
Oh, as they say in the classics, do not adjust your sets. Adelaide by 69 points with 2 minutes still to play in this second term. Dangerfield inside 50. Lynch, that clever pass last time for Walker. He just stepped over and in it will come again on the elbow.
They've got some depth too when you think of the names that are out at the moment. Thompson, Kerridge, you know, those sort of guys as well. Podsy Adley if they need as well.
Betts with 3 goals. Walker on screen a moment ago with 3 goals, 4.
Crouch is the other very big out. He'll come back in a couple of months.
Swallows kick. Not quite. McKay gathers. Back towards Walker. Well done, Tippett that time in front. Jenkins, good handball. Thompson got in the road. Jacobs, the clearing kick.
To a one-on-one, and then Laird chipped in. So well done by Talia there. Just to wrap up, Petrie. So Laird just sits it. Betts will be the fly. Not quite. Jacobs. Cunnington. And Cunnington off a step. What can they take into half-time, North Melbourne? Thomas wanting to buy some time and space. Flips it back. D'Alessandro, good hands. Nothing coming easy, though. In the back against Sloan. Atlee. Gibson. Normally these guys are prolific. They need a goal. They need about 10 of them. We know that. This is their best chance. Bastardak and Harvey. I think it's a goal. It's a goal to Bastardak. Well, that it seems insignificant in a way, but just to get through the press. I mean, that's what you've got to do if you're North.
Well, the thing is about you'll get through the press three or four times a game, but for the rest of the game, you can't score. So that's what the press is all about. Every now and again, the press up, the side will get over the top and kick a goal or two, and you always... And Kangaroos have done that two, three times, but they've only kicked three goals because for the rest of the time, the ball just keeps bouncing back into the Crows forward line.
So 46 minutes since that last goal from Higgins, eh?
And that was their last score, Bruce. So they get a goal with less than a minute remaining in this term. And the new coach, Phil Walsh, is on his feet, heading downstairs already, Ellis Yeoman. He's lifted as this game's gone on, found the tempo of it in his second AFL footy. Jacobs gets it from Sloan. They might not be finished with yet. Right. Takes on Thompson. Van Berlo was the target. Didn't quite stick. Gibson, McMillan. Clock counting down.
Wait. Petrie. On the left. Laird's been terrific in this opening half. So Adelaide close to the biggest first half they've ever had in round one. They got 84 points against the Blues a few years back. There's Phil Walsh. It was the day that Modra kicked 13. Well, there'll be a lot of thoughts for both the coaches at halftime. I mean, but for the new guy, it's the perfect scenario. Much of the same. He'll be saying to his players, right, just so hard to maintain this intensity and also this control over a match, but it's been a remarkable opening half. Adelaide kicked 10 goals 7 lead in 45 minutes of footy without a reply before the Bassett
had goal. Fantastic. Well, what two things we like in footy. We like a contest eventually. There's no contest today, but this is a fantastic exhibition of the sport.
And Dangerfield's been front and centre. Down to you, Jude, with Patrick Dangerfield.
Paddy, complete domination across the ground, especially around the midfield. The new coach must be pretty happy.
Yeah, look... We're happy, but it's half-time. So, you know, we've played a half of footy. We need to play four quarters to beat quality sides like we know North Melbourne are. So it starts with our contested ball, our ground balls. And we were really poor with our tackling in the first quarter, even though we were on top on the scoreboard. And felt that we improved that area in the second quarter.
That pressure was really evident, the forward press.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's where we want to play, you know, the game in our forward half. We only get that if we apply really solid pressure on the opposition. And that's what we've done.
Good luck in the second half, mate.
Time at the Adelaide Oval, and it is the new look Adelaide Crows with that man as their captain, Phil Walsh, as their coach. They're leading by 63 points. That's right, 63 points. 10 goals, 7 unanswered at one stage during that second term before North Melbourne got a goal late. It was their only score of the second quarter. So 63 points it is at halftime. An incredible game of footy, and there's a lot more to come. Last night, of course, still side bottom. It was the big injury out of Collingwood's victory over the Brisbane Lions. Tom Brown spoke to him at the airport.
Oh, it's not great, but I'm going to get an x-ray now, so I'll find out from that. Hopefully it's not as bad, but yeah, I don't know. I've got no idea. So,
how much pain were you in initially?
Not too much. I actually thought I might have dislocated at the start, but yeah, I don't think that's the case. But yeah, I'll find out now and then I'll be right.
Tom Brown with Steel Sidebottom. More on that on 7 News tonight. All of your footy news, of course, on 7 News. Full time at the Etihad Stadium and GWS. They've done it again. They've won their round one fixture, Sydney last year and this year over St Kilda by 9 points. Jeremy Cameron, we heard from Lee earlier about young forwards who are being paid a lot of money. Well, I think this man deserves whatever he is getting. 4 goals today, a very promising start to his season. We know how good, how athletic and what a great mark he is. He's a fantastic finisher as well. So 4 goals, terrific for GWS, one of the expansion clubs. Gold Coast losing yesterday, GWS winning today. That's a great start for them. Now, an incident late in the game which sat Nick Revolt down. Obviously St Kilda not with a win today, and this a little unsavoury as well. Thomas Bugg collecting him and collecting him
pretty solidly. Now, Nick Riewoldt did get up. You can see it left of screen there. Bug going for the football. Riewoldt in his road, and it was very strong and forceful contact into his back. His neck was assessed, all the usual precautions. Eventually, he was on his feet and OK. So, fingers crossed for Nick Riewoldt. Well, we're not sure what's going to get the job done for North Melbourne. They're in all sorts of bother. Jude Bolton with their captain, Andrew Swallow.
Andrew, the pressure around the footy was enormous from Adelaide. How do you claw yourself back into this game?
Oh, we just got to wipe that half. Nothing went right. We gave a lot of easy goals away, got smashed in the middle. So we just got to come out now and just pretend like we're starting again. Get in, win the hard footy and just make it a really dogfight.
Good luck, mate.
Thanks, mate.
Well, you wonder what they've got. 3-1-19 North Melbourne. The Adelaide Crows, 12-10-82. New captain, new coach, and everything going beautifully for them. Back with Lee and Bruce right after this.
So Sean Higgins in his first game for the club. This is his very first kick, his first two kicks for North Melbourne goals. He only had the three kicks. He's kicked a couple, but the team has been bereft, haven't they? It was 46 minutes between his second goal, Higgins, and their third before half-time from Bastinac. Not a good day for any players, but it's been a terrific career for Sam Gibson. A mature age player, he debuted on round 12, 2012 against Gold Coast Suns. And believe it or not, he has not missed a match since. 61 consecutive games, including today. It's been a tough journey.
I came out of under-18s at Oakley Chargers and I guess wasn't ready for AFL yet, so chose to play in the VFL, and combining that with uni at the same time, which was a pretty good part-time job for me. But then a few years into my VFL career, I got an opportunity at Hawthorn to be on their rookie list, something that was a great opportunity at the time but only lasted a year, unfortunately. And from that position, I went back to Box Hill, which was the club I loved, and continued to play there, and it wasn't until I was about 25 that North Melbourne came knocking. I didn't train and play to get drafted. I just, as long as I kept seeing improvements in my game, that was enough motivation for me, and this was probably just the end result of that. It just puts into perspective a bit. You sort of know what the other side's like, going to have and having to work and combine footy as well, and it just lets you appreciate. So most days I usually try and sort of take time to think about how lucky I am to be doing this job when many other guys don't get the opportunity. Try and work harder than everyone else on the list, because getting there's one thing, but actually hanging around and playing is a completely different thing as well.
He goes back to Gibson, 20 out, he's got the goal! North are back within 3 points!
You can't hide anymore, it's such a fast-paced game, you have to be able to run. And every player's got different strengths, and it's something that I have to work still really hard at, because I guess that's my point of difference for a lot of other players. I think I feel that a lot of the mature age guys are very good at a lot of things, but there's never sort of one thing that really sort of sets them apart from everywhere else. So to have that one attribute that's, I guess, elite, or something that's elite at AFL level is really helpful. And I think that's probably how I got into the AFL system.
Finds Gibson. Gibson steps inside the 50, lines up. Well worked, North Melbourne.
Our success is determined by what our coaches and teammates think of us. I guess it's nice every now and then to see you get a little bit of recognition outside of our four walls, but I don't really think that it's something that I needed.
Just the perfect comment. All happening here at the Adelaide Oval, boom, crash, opera. And the second half coming up, Adelaide lead by 63 points.
Welcome back to the Adelaide Oval. What a half it's been for the Adelaide Crows. What a half-time it's been for the Oz Kickers, the NAB Oz Kickers back for 2015. Great to see the kids out there running around, having a great time. Participation, of course, is the key. It's not about who wins or loses, just getting out there. And we thank NAB for their terrific support, again, of this wonderful football institution. Still exciting to kick a goal, though, isn't it? North could do with a few goals. Jude Bolton and Mark Soderstrom are riding the boundary for us this afternoon. Jude, Mark, it looks like a long way back for North from here.
Absolutely, Baz. So does the pressure around the footy from the Adelaide Crows. They've just been enormous. Just the last year, they conceded about 110 points per game against the top eight teams, against the bottom eight teams. You know, they were conceding 75 points against. Just their pressure around the footy has been enormous today.
Well, they were punished more than any other team in the competition for their team. turnovers, and I think something like 64% of the score from the opposition came from those turnovers. We talked about that frenetic pressure a little earlier. That was the one thing that Phil Walsh highlighted he wanted to bring to this club, and they're doing it magnificently at the moment. And what like Taylor Walker, he's kicked 3-4, Jude, and I reckon if we go back...
He's had a few more opportunities too.
Absolutely. He's taken 12 marks. North Melbourne as a team have only taken 19. But take it back 22 years ago, there was a bloke called Tony Modra in this town, and he tore Adelaide apart. He was that good. We know that Taylor was a little reluctant to take the captaincy, but we don't want to go a little early. I know we're only half a game into the season, but
could he be as big as Modra?
I'll tell you what, he is well on the way. There is no doubt about that. He has been absolutely magnificent.
A couple of low numbers for North. Wells has only had the 4 disposals. Del Santo, 8. Higgins, 8. Harvey's only had the 8 as well. So they need to get their hands on the footy.
Alternatively, you look at Adelaide there. Dangerfield, 18. Sloan's had 16. Great to see Nathan Van Berlo back. His first game since 2013. He's looked good. And Phil Walsh, he loves talking about sport around the world, Jude. And he said that there's one thing he took out of going to Chelsea and listening to Jose Mourinho, the boss there of the English Premier League side. He said at halftime he likes to give his players just the 3 messages. Doesn't want to overload them mentally. So you can imagine right now, he's kept it simple with the Crows. The number one message, defensive pressure.
It's worked pretty well. Opening bounce of the second half. So can North stem the flow here? Make an early mark. Wells to Cunnington. Cunnington's kick to the goal square. Running away, but Harding able to get back. So North didn't score anything for 46 minutes. From early-ish in the first quarter to deep, deep, deep in the second. Sometimes not an easy half to play when you're 10 goals in front. I know that sounds ridiculous, but it's only one way to go in a way. I mean, can Adelaide maintain the rage, maintain the standard? Sloan, who kicked 2 first half goals. To Harvey's free kick. It's impossible to think they'll be so dominant in the second half, isn't it?
Well, it doesn't. It tends to not work out that way because the opposition just have to find a level.
Higgins, Cunnington. So Cunnington getting involved a bit early. Higgins, he's already kicked 2, and that's a good-looking kick, and he's kicked 3. First game for North Melbourne today.
See how he's a natural goal kicker, Higgins. He's a good kicker to football, but he just sort of he knows where the goals are and just tends to be able to take the half chances.
So Zeeble now sending them forward again. This is a better start from North Melbourne. That was dangerous. Henderson had his legs taken out from under him. Weight came hard, but I don't think there's any doubt with that. He did take his legs out. I think the sub's been made too. Tippett for Gibson. We'll check that with the boys downstairs in just a moment. Here's Laird. Fires out a handball. Smith. Jentsch got it from Jacobs. Goldstein, well done. He was right there. They are playing better. Intensity's gone up. Wells goes to the pocket. Thomas, rather. The ball wasn't touched, I don't think. Getting back and making sure Brown and a behind.
That's right, boys. The sub has been made. Turner is now on, and it leaves now Ferrito on the dangerous Taylor Walker.
OK, so Tippett, the tall defender, but Walker dominating him in that opening half, as we know. Tippett's brother, of course, well known here. That's a poor kick. Adelaide, Douglas, not so good. And the kick to 4-4. Wells and also Turner going for the same ball. Wells, little kick. Now Turner can kick a goal. And he does. Comes onto the ground. No touch off the boot. Unlucky. I reckon Phil Walsh wouldn't have liked this 3 minutes so far.
No, they've actually had to come out and really find something in this first bit of the game. I mean, the game is probably gone even on the scoreboard, but in terms of general play.
Tony, come back 3 metres. Hold now.
So the mark okay. Jacobs got it from Cheney. He's been good, Cheney. Douglas. He had a sloppy period in the opening term, but really improved since then and been A1.
Thank you.
And now Jentsch just held up by Turner.
Baz, keep an eye on Luke Brown here. Looks like he's heading to the sidelines with a bit of an injury to the right leg.
You get on your sodas, keep us informed. It's a long kick down towards full forward. McMillan did okay, then got in the road. And now bringing the football out nicely. North Melbourne do it okay. That's a very good mark taken by Waite. It was Attlee. Now Turner, he's had an impact, but that not his best effort. And right on the line, it's just inside the field of play.
A couple of kicks for Turner early. So Brown
off the ground. It'll be interesting to see if Adelaide do make the sub. Lyons is their sub today. He's a versatile player. He can go back if they need him. So North have kicked the last two goals of the match. Late in the first half, early in the second. Goal seemed brilliantly done. Thomas roved it well. North's intensity right up. Smith was clever there. He's going to sock it off the ground, then decided not to. Took the ball, but McMillan cut it off. So North pressing here. Good response. Brad's got to be happy with his start. Sets it up. Wait. Not quite. Sloan was the defender, really. Not Hardigan in the end. Hardigan was done, and it was Sloan helping out. Wait over the ball. And a ball up.
They've just got to cash in on a little bit of momentum here. They've had 7 inside 50s to 1 so far, North Melbourne.
So they're at their end of the ground. Goldstein, well done. Higgins, Dangerfield, very clever. Got it to Douglas. Douglas left it behind first time. Grabs it the second time. Kick, not great though. And Thompson camped under it. Can send it back in now. Is it a short option or will he go long? White is in the square. He pulls the kick a little. Zeebel, well done, Jacobs. Drifted across. Made it a 2-on-1 and knocked it over the line. Had a big game, the big ruckman.
There's Brown being worked on. Plays a bit like Nick Smith for Sydney. He's a terrific small defender. Thomas.
Eye contact. North Melbourne.
It's good then, Thomas.
That's your life. Thanks, Lindsay.
He got the movement through the contest, and as soon as you get to really attack the ball hard, ground level, it just puts the pressure on the tacklers. All the Crows guys went at him, but just probably one Dean to be a little high when he went as he went to ground.
He draws them, we know that.
Yeah.
He's a mighty fine player. So looking for his 250th goal career. We saw Taylor Walker kick his 200th today. Averages exactly the same number of goals as Eddie Betts, within about 200s, and he's got it home. So North eroding this big margin slowly.
So the last three goals of the game for North Melbourne. Is there a little spark here now?
They're on the first two centre bounces, so this is where it has to start. Can they get the ball forward and put the pressure on again?
Well, Goldstein right on cue, did brilliantly down to Swallows. Swallows kick favoured Henderson. Well done by the sub. He's on the ground. He got it to Higgins. That was well done by Turner. Now out wide. Bastinek bouncing ball. Wait. Hardigan did well. It comes back to Petrie. It's a high, long shot on goal. 4 in a row, North Melbourne.
So 12 of the last 14 inside 50s. And more importantly, the last 4 goals. And North have cut this margin.
The Crows have to try and stem this fight back right here at the centre bounce just to try and make sure they get the ball there forward of centre.
Ellis Yeoman goes to ground. Dangerfield cuts across in front of Cunnington. Henderson, but they're on the back foot, Adelaide. Cheney, Wells was terrific. Combative. Dal Santo. And he's going to be pinged.
Dived on it there, Nick.
And Soda's just a quick update on Brown.
Yeah, Adelaide doctor just getting the run up and down the boundary line. That right thigh is heavily strapped. They've had him on the bike just to keep it moving to see if he will be okay. It's a corky there at the moment. Jared Lyons just sitting there eagerly, so I reckon they'll make the call in the next minute or two on him.
So Cheney, Adelaide going to centre wing, is about as far forward as they've been for the whole half. North are probably 2 goals away from really feeling like there are a big chance. I mean, the players do, but in terms of our general expectation.
Great, Mark Goldstein. He was outnumbered there. It was a 3-on-1 situation. It was a high ball, perfect kick in the end, and good Mark Goldstein, who's lifting. As are North Melbourne, the last 4 goals of the game. To the pocket. That's a very clever mark by Thomas. Wow.
It's an important thing in all those emotional, mental things that go on with the collectively within the Chiefs. Mind now the Kangaroos are playing better. Man, they're playing better than the Crows right now. Big margin of make-up. But they're now the team that's making the play.
He kicked 45 goals last season. He's a very, very good player. 53 the year before. Of course, going back before that, he was a player who suffered quite badly from the yips. This for five in a row for North. Oh, that's a very good kick. Here we go.
Now, reckon.
Well, Thomas' second goal. They've kicked five goals in 13 minutes, counting that one at Bassanac before half time.
Have a look at the personnel in the centre bounce for the Crows. I'd be getting Dangerfield or Sloan's in there, but they need to just get the ascendancy back here.
Well, Cunnington to Dow Santo, short. And Thomas has kicked two in this term.
I'm just thinking Dangerfield's deep forward at the moment, but just at this point of time, you have to get your best centre bounce crew in the centre bounce to give you the best chance of stemming it at the source.
Stay nice, Charlie. Eddie.
Of Kangaroos have won every centre bounce to this in this third quarter.
15 seconds.
Phil Walsh is his first real challenge, I reckon, today. Right now.
Yeah, well, I suppose.
Thanks, Eddie.
Certainly is.
Well, this is huge if we can kick this. This is the sort of margin that Sydney gave Essendon yesterday, and Brisbane were behind. Collingwood couldn't quite make it up, but this is manageable now if we can get this home. It was touched off the boot, so Sauce is going to have to get rid of it. I think he's gone.
They always give you a chance when it's touched off the boot. It's almost like the holding the ball rule doesn't count because they think they've marked it.
I think he was lucky.
Yeah.
Goldstein, Bastanac. Out on the full.
Adelaide kick.
Oh, this has been terrific by North Melbourne. At halftime, you just wondered if this match would just meander to a conclusion.
Yes, that Collingwood were 53 points in front of the Lions, pretty late in the third quarter, and the Lions got within.
And what about Sydney and Essendon?
Sydney's last quarter was obviously a domination, 7-6 to nil.
Henderson up in front, Jacobs. Over the footy now, Jacobs for North Melbourne. Comes up the back, Ellis Yeoman got the ball away. Good little handball, the kick not good, and McMillan holds them up again. So, can they come forward? Well done by the skipper, Swallow. He beat the tackle, gave it off. Harvey did well. Swallow again, just a little blanket. Well done, Eddie Betts. That was an important role that he played there. They were coming again. Ferrito's free, I think.
Michael Ferrito high.
Taken high. He wants to go. So they've got plenty of run in their legs now. Suddenly it's North Melbourne up on their toes. It's like we're seeing two different games of football this afternoon.
And Thomas flies high. Wells, only the four disposals in the first half, but getting busier. Laird, well done, Attlee. Dow Santo getting heavily involved. Kicks to full forward. Bastanac, Cheney. Well read by Hardigan. Cheney did the job. McKay coughed it up. Back, Gibson off a step. And gets it. And North are coming really hard now. It's official, they're back in business. So this is just a little bit of what's been happening in the second half.
This is where it started, they're just winning all the centre bounces. So the Crows at this next centre bounce, I think they've got... I'd be getting Dangerfield in there, I'd be getting Sloan in there. Get your best centre bounce players in there because this is where Kangaroos have taken over the game.
Jenkins wins the hit out, it was coming out. Smith did well, got in the road, Jenkins. Now there's a chance. Ellis, Yeoman and Walker on the lead, and that's better from Adelaide. 10 consecutive goals for the Adelaide Crows in this game, and then the next six for North Melbourne. This to stem the tide just a touch.
They finally won a centre bounce, and as he's been doing so well, Walker just dropping into space now. Now the pressure's on to just stem the flow, to reverse the tide by making sure the opportunity becomes the six-pointer.
Just the second inside 50 for Adelaide this term for his fourth goal. The skipper, that's what you want the captain to do. He stands up.
So Dangerfield goes into the middle.
Dangerfield's gone into the centre bounce. Douglas is still in there, and Betts, who is a bit of a bit part centre bounce player.
So four to Walker, but Goldstein dominating there. Got the best of the bounce. Dow Santo to full forward. Thomas courageously. Cheney. Hardigan on the back foot, but did well. Back to Cheney. Yench to support if he wants. Cheney short to Jenkins. So Walker, four goals for. He's had 13 marks and kicked four goals for. Wow. Colossal numbers. But North challenging. They're a long way back, but the whole momentum has shifted. Betts. We talked about the fact that he's been in the centre square a lot. Smith. Beautiful kick to Douglas. Dangerfield's inside of him. Douglas decides to go to Cameron. Well done, McDonald.
And McDonald did a great job there because Cameron was always going to be dangerous in that situation.
Adelaide have to curb Goldstein. He's had 9 hit-outs this quarter, 6 to advantage. So he's just getting his hand to it and just putting it down the throat of their midfielders.
And yet Jacobs had such a good first half, didn't he?
Yep.
He's lifted the ruckman. Harvey doing the kicking in. It was a tough one. Del Santo was the target, so they're dangerous here. McKay now with his hands on it. Sloan upended. Didn't really have the football. Bastinac got him.
Held on too long, I think. Was that the umpire's call?
It was a good tackle initially. The ball spilt out, Lee, and then the tackle came. So no worries with that one. Sloan goes towards the pocket. Walker! How about that?
Now that's balance and body strength. He knew where the fall of the ball was going to be, but he had to take a step inboard to make sure that Ferrito couldn't actually get to the fall of the ball. See, he comes inboard, makes contact. Great body use under the footy.
His career high is 16 marks. That beauty, an absolute specky at the Adelaide Oval, makes it number 14. And he's kicking now for goal number 5.
Yep. Career high 6, which he's done a couple of times, Baz.
And he's best at the Adelaide Oval. This is to equal it. And he's kicking, well, in a masterful performance. It could be even better. That's 4 goals, 5 now for the big Texan.
Yeah, 9 scoring shots, 9 shots on goal, and probably all of them gettable, I reckon, don't you?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. A bit surprised Scott Thompson hasn't... I mean, he's had a variety of matchups, I know, Walker, but Scott Thompson is their best defensive defender, and Walker is winning the ball so easily up there.
Jacobs, Junior did really well. Down to you guys at the boundary.
The sub's been made, Bruce. Luke Brown, his day is done with a corky there. Jared Lyons on, pretty handy sportsman too, Jared. Plays golf off 7. Good cricketer playing a charity 2020 game over summer. He caught Steve Waugh in an absolute blinding catch in Gully and off the long run bowling, former cult hero Wayne Wiedemann.
Gee, Sodas, that's good information. Where's his best place on the footy field, do you reckon? He can play anywhere, can't he?
He's good. We've seen him kick a few goals in the past, Max, so he's out there firing up and ready to go.
Gee, Dangerfield was important there. Van Berlo just missed the target. Gibson. Terrific contest going on. Here's Lyons at the moment. Betts. Read it pretty well. Knew that the coming Turner was one of them. Betts slung away. Turner's been good. Wells. Cheney into him. Wells. Hot footy right now. Real contest. Well played, young Turner. He was the youngest player on the list, anyone's list last year, and he hasn't made an impact since coming on.
He's ferocious at the football, there's no doubt about that. Here's Harvey, ran into trouble, had to retreat. Back to Thompson, who spills the mark. Tough one now, Lynch was coming at him. Jacobs needs to be clean. Well, he got it to right somehow. I'm not sure that it was clean. Thompson now, Ferrito, and they've done well to stand up under pressure. Here's McDonald, a good young player. How about the kick? Not terrific. Douglas marks in front of Turner now. He can go to the outer side. There are players on. Eddie Betts is on his own. He's got a runner inside in Sloan. Will he use him? 2 bounces. Now 3 for Eddie. Assesses the option. Has a 4th. Gives it to Rory. Pops it over the top. Jenkins.
Good use. He was good, Betts, then. He was approaching the 50-metre line. I think he was wanting to get inside 50 and have a shot, but he knew he was on the angle. Sloan got the support. That's good forward use. All 4 players picked the right target and he ended up having a shot for goal from 45 degrees, maybe 30 metres out.
Rory, that's your line. Mark's right here.
It was a beautiful build-up by Eddie Betts. It was just a question of whether he hung onto it maybe a little too long or not. But in the end, Sloan to Jenkins and now to Laird. He kicked just 2 goals last season, 3 for his career only. And he's nailed it. That's an important goal for Adelaide, really important. Their lead's back to 44 points.
Well, I feel like we're watching a good TV show at the moment, a good movie. And what is your, thinking of Presto, what is your favourite?
I went for a few good men.
And why not? Jack Nicholson gives one of the great coaching speeches of all time. So, 30-day free offer. Betts, up the ground, Betts again. So in that centre square, so a different role. A real veteran now, Eddie.
and so does... it was tipped that he might play a little more midfield this year.
He was so dangerous up forward, though, Bruce. Now he's got that Eddie Betts pocket just in front of the scoreboard there. He has spent a little bit of time there in the pre-season. We saw him even down back a little earlier in the game, but he's been so dangerous up there and a great foil to Walker.
Just thinking, Lee, it might have been like a few good men for the North Melbourne players at half-time for Brad Scott. You want the truth? You can't handle the truth. But they came out hard. And their improvement has been marked in their second term. Now, McMillan across half-back, still driving. It was a very good kick, and the mark taken by Cunnington. He dishes off to Nicky Dell. He goes short. Oh, Cheney, very good mark. Higgins was the target. Maybe better off just blazing away then. Gee, Cheney's been good, and McKay's kick to Lynch. Was it on the line? Out of bounds on the full.
Umpire in a good spot. You know, Cheney has been terrific. He played 9 games last year, 4 the year before, 6 the year before that, 8 the year before that for Hawthorne. So, and something similar at Melbourne. So, oh, that's a terrible bit of play by Wells. You don't say that too often. Cut off by Wright. Cameron will be hard to catch. Wells tries to corral him now. Cameron sets it up. Walker's not in a good spot. Ferrito takes the mark. It was a poor kick. And then Ferrito. Attlee's a run and carrier, but this is Thompson. Attlee in front of him. Mate. Now he gets to Attlee. Attlee held up, good tackle, swung around. Van Berlo corralling Thompson, pushes him in the back. Free kick to the North Melbourne defender.
Brilliant tackle by Smith, wasn't it?
Yep.
Just a bit unlucky there, Adelaide. But the free kick was there.
It's not easy to get down, Attlee.
They've so markedly improved their tackling, chasing, just the whole intensity, the football, the Kangaroos. I mean, that was sadly lacking in the first half, but they've picked that up. So now this is a really good contest.
Goldstein, Jacob, speaking of really good contest, that has been a beauty. Ellis Yolman with a handball up the line and over it goes. So it's just a bit of a breather now for everyone, isn't it? North Melbourne ferocious to start this third term. And with three and a little bit to play, North, another one or two, probably need two to be in the game. Goldstein did really well there, uses right. Here's a chance now, Talia and Petrie, favours Talia, Petrie right there with him. Interesting, well played by the big fella, the 33-year-old. Petrie got his hand all the way to Higgins, clever fist, Van Berlo clean bowled, Zeeble comes again. Here's Thomas, clever, got away from Yench. No, he didn't, the umpire said.
Gee, Yench was good because Thomas was really trying to turn him inside out. What a great quarter of footy this has been. I mean, North came out steaming and Adelaide now responding. It's just a contest, isn't it?
Yeah, well, that's exactly what happened. They just were a little bit sluggish early third quarter. The Crows, the Kangaroos knew it was now or never. And they won those centre bounces, kicked the 5 goals. But now the Crows have kicked a couple and all of a sudden have stabilised the game. Not blitzing like they were in the first half, but now fairly even Stevens in general play.
Attlee on the burst, getting from Cunnington, who's been terrific in this quarter. And that's a beautifully weighted kick. And this guy is having some sort of a debut. It's been a little cameo role.
Short.
Higgins.
Yeah,
so
that's your line,
3 goals.
Yeah, you're right, Michael.
And coming up for his 13th disposal.
Super work from Attlee there, just to change pace, cut them up and just deliver inside 50. North Melbourne have actually butchered the footy going forward the last couple of times. That was a really quality entry.
Well, in good hands here, Jude, and they need this. A goal here, and you feel like they've got something to really work with at three-quarter time in terms of winning this match. Holding the line. He's kicked 4 goals. That's a big, big debut now.
Sean Higgins with 4 goals last time he kicked 4, April 2009 against the West Coast Eagles. So they got one. We're back to 38 points. Can they get another with just over 2 minutes to play in this third term? Would make it really interesting. Eddie Betts with other ideas, but well done, McDonald. What a good young defender he is. Swings the handball to right. And now up the line for Zeeble, who drops what he had on his chest, and now a careless high ball. So Adelaide are in here when they shouldn't have been. Right, takes the mark, and well, Brad Scott will be furious with that. Talia pushing down.
He's been good, Tali. I mean, he's been mostly on Petrie. Very clearly won that contest.
So just over 90 seconds remaining in this third term. Good fist away. That was well done by McMillan on Sloane. And Zeeble cleaner that time. Got it to right. Around the corner. Bouncing ball midfield. Big ball to win this one. And Bastanac wins it.
Burst through. Kicks to Harvey. He's had very few chances today. Henderson's quick. We know Boomer is well played, Harvey. Can he turn him around? Henderson corrals him. Did a great job, Henderson. Right to cut it off, perhaps. Cheney, Harvey a second go and kicks it out on the full. Ricky Henderson, well played. Even at nearly 37, Boomer's not easy to corral.
No, that's right. He's still got his speed, as we've said, Harvey, but he corralled him. He just made sure that the boundary line was going to protect him, make sure that he couldn't. He was always going to turn him. He was going to always try and turn him, but Henderson played it well.
He had one attribute, Henderson, which was important. He's quick. You've got to be that to do that to Harvey.
Jacobs stood up, couldn't mark. Ellis Yeoman got it from Talia, gave it back. Now Dangerfield. Petrie chasing him. A goal here, Adelaide, would be massive. Absolutely massive. Lynch plays on. Goes to Charlie Cameron. Here's their chance. Pops it over the top, Eddie Betts. He's got a man on Jenkins. Kicks for him. Jenkins marks. Great play, Adelaide.
Could have messed it up, but Betts actually was just making Jenkins go to the open field. Jenkins, as long as he kept his eyes on the ball, Betts was going to find him. Here we see Harvey, just really well played by Henderson, just made him, didn't allow him to turn, but Betts, have a look at this, he knows exactly what he's doing, inside space,
seconds.
So that the North Melbourne defender just can't get to Jenkins.
A really important player for Adelaide, he kicked 40 goals last season, this is his 10th disposal for his second goal. Won't quite call it a game killer, but it will make it very, very difficult for North Melbourne. If Jenkins can slot this one.
Siren's gone, so it doesn't matter. You can take it. No, it doesn't.
So Josh Jenkins after the siren. It's going to be really hard for North now. 44 points the margin. 15-12, 102. North Melbourne 9-4-58. Adelaide wrestle a little back that they lost in that third term. North Melbourne better, but it's Adelaide's game to lose now. Back with the last quarter right after this.
So 6-3 to 3-2 in that quarter. North really doing it from the centre clearances. Walker again important. He kicked a goal against the flow, but North's run and carry were pretty impressive there. Lindsay Thomas got busy. Swallow got a couple of clearances. Goldstein had a fantastic quarter. Sloane's been good, as you'd expect. He's kicked up a couple of goals today. Adelaide got a big lead. North got a little closer than this through the turn, but at three-quarter time, it's Adelaide 15-12 to North 9-4. And it really is fantastic. Presto.com.au with any TV show or movie that you'd like on demand. Great way to spend a night. Jude and Soda's down to you guys. Gee, what a good quarter of footy we've just seen.
It was amazing, Jude, wasn't it? In that second quarter, we saw the Crows dominated clearances 17-4. You talked about Goldstein's influence during that third term. It was enormous.
He was enormous. He was just getting his hand to the footy. He had 11 hit-outs, six of those to effective, just straight to advantage, and it just allowed them to get on top around the stoppages. Kane Turner was good around the stoppages, as well as Del Santo really got his hand on the footy, but those late goals just really hurt them.
Contested possession, a big swing as well.
Yeah, just plus 12 in contested possession, North Melbourne. So they really put the energy back into this contest. They just needed to just start well again this quarter.
Fatigue's pretty interesting in round one, too,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, no, the chasing pressure's going to drop off because that's almost automatic, so it's a question of obviously which side wins the ball first, but then you just got to maintain possession because you get killed on the turnover.
Phil Walsh's first game in charge of these Adelaide Crows. Can he get them home? Dangerfield out of the middle, start of the final turn, down to Walker. Ferrito there. Just a chop of the arms. It was clever. How about that follow-up from Dangerfield? It deserves a goal! Beautiful. It's already one of the goals of the year. Oh, boy!
Yeah, it's well, as you said, Baz, he cleared it from the centre bounce and then collected it from the scrimmage in the forward 50 and kicked the nice left-foot goal. It's
I mean, sometimes it's not so much the free kick. That's a fantastic finish from this point. Left foot, non-dominant side, kick the goal. But he was the one who got the ball to that part of the ground in the first place. It's a double whammy. Fantastic effort by Dangerfield.
Oh, he's some sort of a player.
Yeah, he's been great.
I think everybody in Adelaide's just thrilled a bit. So probably a few people down at Geelong are smiling. I shouldn't bring it up, should I?
When will the new hospital be finished and is Patrick staying? That's the big question here in Adelaide.
What a game he's played, Lee. I mean,
he's been good, outstanding.
So Swallow, Cunnington. Well done, Douglas. On the left. Walker tries to split them all. McDonald. What a fine young player he is. And a boundary throw in.
He plays with such penetration, Dangerfield. He's had his 23 disposals, 14 kicks, but the meter gained stat, he's by far the highest meters gained player on the field because he gets such penetration with his ball carries, run, and then his long kicking.
Well, in the Brownlow, he's had 21, 22 and 23 votes in the last 3 years.
Yep.
You'd feel one night he'll have it hanging around his neck.
He's noticeable.
Probably like a fairest and best as well, wouldn't he? Yench, long ball back towards the square. Ferrito, not sure if he hit the ball. Walker, swung onto the left. He's kicked five. A handful for the Texan in his first game as skipper.
Leave it. Michael, out of it. Rory.
That Adelaide crowd will love this. A little bit of bare-chested from that big fella.
You'd take your time putting your shirt back on if you look like him, wouldn't you?
Yeah, he's definitely taking his time to put it back on, Bruce.
Hey, Jude, you're pretty happy when you've done the hard yards in the gym when this happens.
He's got this crowd eating out the palm of his hand at the moment.
He didn't rip his own shirt off.
Like Dangerfield or Walker. Walker or Dangerfield. Dangerfield or Walker. Who's they putting on a clinic today, those two?
Who gets the three votes from you?
Oh, I think Dangerfield for me.
Think about it, Lee. So Dangerfield for Jude. So fantastic response here from Adelaide, from I guess their two highest profile players. Sloan, well, he's the third musketeer in that popularity contest. He's a beauty. Thomas. Now can North respond again? They were very good in the third quarter. Well done, Talia. Gee, I tell you what, Talia might get the coach's vote. He's been brilliant. Laird goes back. Right. Lions off a step, poor kick, and Ferrito takes the mark. Tully has been superb, hasn't he?
He has been fantastic, yep. No, he's not emerging, he's All-Australian last year, but one of the younger forwards, defenders that have just come through.
Harvey to Swallow, back to Harvey.
Bastinac now. Handball not good for McDonald. Bastinac tried to get it back. He tripped Dangerfield, I reckon. No free. Lions carried forward. Jacobs as well. They've been terrific here, Adelaide. Lynch stands up for them as well. The kick, though, didn't look just a kick in hope. And the mark taken by Scott Thompson. And he'll slow things down for North Melbourne.
Oh, Taylor there. No closer.
Now, Cunnington. Haven't seen a lot of this, Lee, to be fair. There hasn't been much slow movement of the ball.
Both sides have actually tried to move it quickly, which is why there's been, 17 goals to 9 scored.
McMillan's kick was a dangerous one for Attlee, but it got there. Ditto that handball. Jacobs did all right, though. Long ball down towards the 50. Thomas just overran it. Well done, Yench. He's so cool. Good in this situation. Thomas came back hard with the smother and over the line.
There's an element that early in the season, players are playing under a lot of fatigue because they're not match hardened. And sometimes the type of football in the early part of the season is kind of the argument for the spectacle's better when players are a bit tighter.
Yeah.
Because the defensive... But as players get match hardened, the games tighten up because the defensive work rate becomes greater.
Lee, I think one of the other things, the conditions are so good here today, aren't they?
Yeah, well,
compared with, say, a greasy night match.
Yep.
So Walker's kicked forward to the 50. Ferrito's got Betts hanging on to him. He was good, Betts. His closing speed important. So 44% of his disposals inside the forward 50 today. Last year it was 58%. So he has been up the ground a lot more. He's still got three goals.
He's been in a lot of centre bounces.
And still managed three goals.
Yep.
So Jacobs and Goldstein, been a fantastic clash.
Swallow, bottom of the pack. Well done, McMillan. Good tackle, Laird. He's a tough customer, Laird. Douglas, a high ball back towards Jenkins. Eddie Betts went back with a fly. North
against Walker. Ferrito.
But a North Melbourne free kick. And it is Ferrito's. That was courageous by Eddie Betts. Del Santo, short one. Harvey, good mark at full stretch.
Andrew Swallow just making his way to the bench now. He looks pretty sure.
Good on you. So does Del Santo now. Follows up, running hard. Wait. Hardigan with him. Interesting this one, the 33-year-old. Giving up some ground now. Well done. Henderson arrived to support. Wait's done well as well. He came back hard. Hardigan in the end. The numbers telling the story for the time being anyway. And Smith is such a composed defender. Cheney's been terrific on debut for the Adelaide Crows. And that's a great mark by Ellis Yolman.
Just his second match today. He's done enough. Smith is such a class act, Basil. You're right. I mean, he had to clean up the mess that was being made around him a moment ago. He had a breakout season, but I don't think it was a one-off. I think this guy's going to be...
He's just a good young player, just approaching his early 20s prime.
As he coughs it up, which is so unusual for him. So Turner, the 19-year-old.
Del Santo on the wing.
Hold there.
He's trying hard, Del Santo. This is his 17th disposal. Beaten in the midfield, he hasn't been alone in that area. They had their moments in that third term. Petrie flew high then. Zeeble at the bottom of the pack. Talia again, well done. McKay, Laird, Walker. The kick not good for him. Thompson came back hard, right waiting down. And he sinks the slipper into this one. Henderson, a good fly, and the recovery even better. He takes them on. Go, Ricky Henderson. Away he does go. Perfect kick for Cameron. Lands on his chest. Now he's got Eddie back in the square. Jenkins shorter, doubling back towards the boundary. Eddie needs to control it. He's got it in his hands. What's the next move? Wrong foot's Ferrito. Can he finish from there? No. Just rolls across the line. And a boundary throw in. Well done, Eddie, though. Three goals today, 17 disposals. He's been a star.
No doubt. We said before, a lot of his footy's been up the ground today, but he's still been able to kick the three slow and well done. And Laird just can't quite get the hook. He's been very good, Laird.
That's it.
Brown, the injury
Mark's
today.
Laird's been the marker for Brent Harvey, and it hasn't been a flowing game for the Kangaroos, so... Harvey's worked hard, but certainly hasn't been able to have any great effect on the game.
I think Adelaide's got a pretty good group of smallish defenders, and one of them. Smith's a medium, and he's the standout, but Brown does his job as well.
Throw Jared Waite.
So the old crow throw that time. So Waite hasn't really made a mark today, has he?
No. The ball hasn't been in his end of the field all that much, but... Hardigan and Taylor have both been really good in the tall defensive roles for the Crows.
McMillan's kick was terrific. Onto the chest of Wright, inside the centre square. That's what he's got up in front of him again. Adelaide pushing back, pushing hard. The press is on. It's been effective. Excellent kick, and McDonald takes the mark. Now Thomas plays on quickly. He's got Gibson running. Long ball, Petrie caught behind Talia. And Talia... his reputation continuing to grow. We're only one game into the new season. We know how fantastic he was last year. That kick, not terrific. Cunnington marks, but he's been great today, Lee.
Yeah, no, he has been good. No, they look pretty well balanced, the Crows. Their key forwards are pretty good, or certainly one is really good in Walker. And Hardigan and Talia look like they've got a very competent, tall defenders.
Well, North hasn't had much luck left to screen today. Had one scoring shot in the second quarter, and that took forever. And this is their first real go on goal, and the last Cunnington's kick won't be a score directly. Crows had all the flyers and bounced through for a behind. What sort of a marker do you reckon round one is? I think both the Swans and Hawthorn lost last year in round one, and they played in the grand final, didn't they?
I think that's true. I think it's always nice to have a really good win in round one, because it just gets the morale going, even though, to get the 4 points, obviously, but the win. But it just makes the team feel good if they have a really good result in round one.
Henderson to Hardigan to Douglas. Very good mark, and they're away now. Here's Charlie Cameron. He can get and go. He does go. Does he go short, Eddie, again? Maybe just a little too Eddie conscious that time. Would like to have seen him at full flight, perhaps take it on. But it's a behind, and that lead back to 56 points.
69 points at one stage in that second term. Dangerous kick, but a good one. D'Alessandro on the end of it from McDonald. Attlee, Wright, their dashes off half-back. We just haven't seen much. Speaking of dashes, Henderson has been very, very good to Van Berlo. Henderson off a step, squeezing it forward. Walker outnumbered, Harvey getting back. And then kicking wide and effectively to Gibson. And then Gibson, Turner. He's done enough. He's the only teenager out there for either team. And cops a high one up the front. Going to be a good player, this boy. Controls the kick to Higgins. Couldn't quite take it. Gibson checks sides for goal. And just misses.
All clear.
Behind. We heard about his story at halftime today. And that long, long journey to AFL. And hasn't missed a match since he debuted. 61 consecutive games.
Jensch has been good today. Just his 11th disposal, but done everything required of him. There were two footies on the ground momentarily. Got rid of one of them. Jacobs, big, big fly. It's been his day. Goldstein was busy early. He's got a man on. Hasn't seen the longer option, but he does come short. That's okay. McKay's got it. Now sideways back to Hartigan. Jacobs and Goldstein, Lee, have you seen that one?
Well, yeah, they both had their moments, but I think Jacobs has got the honours on the day. Certainly early in that third quarter, Goldstein's ruck work was outstanding in the centre bounces, but I think in general, I think Jacobs has been more influential.
Terrific kick, Jensch to Sloan. The switch was on. That's a good mark. Goldstein going back. And Cameron, he needed the ball released earlier. Kick into the middle of the ground and Attlee.
And Attlee bounces off Walker and then running hard. Good handball, Zeeble. Back to Gibson. And then Gibson with a neat kick to Thomas. He's had a pretty good second half, Thomas. Had no opportunities really in the second quarter at all.
Lindsay.
He's one of the better small forwards in the comp. He's probably in that top half a dozen, I think, wouldn't you?
He's very dangerous. He's capable of kicking half a dozen on his good days. As Eddie Betts is down the other end, they're both very talented.
He's on it.
But Betts has had another string to his bow today, hasn't he? Being a genuine on ball at times.
So Thomas hugging the line, unfortunately, and never really getting it off the line. 45 goals last year. He's actually kicked slightly more goals than Eddie over the last three when you do the cumulative totals, but they do run parallel in a way, just that Betts has played 50-odd more games.
Well, even today, Bruce, three goals for Eddie, a couple for Lindsay, another shot on goal there. That time out of bounds on the full. Lyons has got the footy, started as the sub. Tough one to mark. Letting down McKay, that was well done. The ball up the line from Jenkins to Eddie Betts. Here's Eddie again. Now, they're just held up here a little, so he might go backwards. Does that to Lyons.
Hold Jack now, hold
they've got
there.
Numbers free in the middle of the ground if he decides to risk it. Not that time. And Laird likes his game today. Been really good. Hard at the footy. No one quite on the mark, so just advances down the line. Jenkins, who started a lot of this off. Eddie Betts was cruising past. Just needed clean hands then from Jenkins on the deck. It didn't quite come. But Adelaide, 55 points up, 9.5 minutes to play. They're going to be well satisfied with their round one output under a new coach in Phil Walsh and led by a new captain, Taylor Walker, with 5 goals, 5.
He's had a remarkable match. Wells, good hands, D'Alessandro. Swinging handball, terrific. Gibson been busy in this term. Back to Attlee. And Attlee imploring Higgins to run on to it with weight. So the two new guys with Hartigan against them. And Hartigan, that's a beautiful handball, actually. Talia off that step. Lynch, good mark. We've got a bit of marking power here, Adelaide. Lynch, he's still not the complete package, Lynch. But he does provide something. Dangerfield outnumbered. McMillan Kick into the centre, Bastinac. Jacobs. Just took too long. Henderson's got better as the match has gone on. Now the fat side gets open up for the Crows. They can run and carry. Walker had a huge match, we know that. And that kick to space is good. Pick up by Dangerfield was brilliant. Kick not so good. Off the side, Wright gets in and takes the mark.
So Wright called the go and does so. Not a good kick. Gibson. Oh, Cheney. Terrific. He's just been outstanding today.
We'll get a game next week. He's done a good job.
Looks like he could well slot into this back six for Adelaide. Jentsch now. High ball. Jenkins the target. Had his hands on it. Couldn't quite complete it. McMillan did well. Here's the Texan for six in his first game as skipper. This will absolutely lift the roof off right back on the line, Marks.
It's good stuff, though, wasn't it? So Gibson, now it opens up for the Kangaroos. Some quick movement. Cunnington to Waite. To Higgins. Higgins with four goals. Back to Waite. Both first gamers for the Kangaroos. Hardigan's got better as the match has gone on as well. Sloan. Short. Van Berlo done enough. Soders, what's the reaction going to be like in your hometown after a performance like this?
There's been a lot of hype over summer, of course. New CEO, new coach, new captain. It's all come together beautifully today. Don't forget, too, Scott Thompson has to come back into this side. And he played an SANFL practice match against West Adelaide as he overcomes a hamstring problem. That was yesterday. He had 22 touches in three quarters of footy. So he could be a big inclusion against Collingwood next Saturday night against Collingwood at Etihad Stadium, that is.
Well, they got Thompson, but he's a certain type. I don't know if there's any laydown was there to add to their midfield mix of size and pace and, you know, in ball getting. He'll have to earn his spot back, I would have thought.
Well, interesting stuff, Ian, and good point you make, perhaps, Lee. I mean, he's been such a club champion over the years, hasn't he?
He's been a really good player, but in terms of their midfield mix, again, he tends to be a ball winner, can get the ball in space, but he's not a ball carrier. He tends to be an accumulator of the footy, so it'd slow the Crows' midfield down a little, I would have thought.
Interesting observation. So Adelaide's draw there looked Collingwood, Western Bulldogs, Melbourne, and then Port Adelaide. So Smith banging, Walker, he's got it. He's got six. What a day. Equals his career high. And Lee Smith, fantastic. What Tex has done today is put a marker down and taken really the pressure off the any controversy about the selection.
Oh, well, yes, I don't. Well, certainly his performance has justified him being the captain. But the captain is about much more than individual performance, and that's why he's actually been given the role of all the things that we don't necessarily see from the outside.
Nine marks inside 50 today, Welsh, for the skipper. The last Adelaide Crows player to do that was Scott Welsh back in 2005, and North Melbourne have taken just five marks inside 50 as a team this afternoon. Nine of them for the new skipper. Six goals, five, as Bruce said, equaling his career best. It's hard to imagine today.
He's also doing what good forwards do. Don't worry about handballing. He's had 20 disposals, all kicks. 20 kicks, 15 marks, six goals, five. Big day.
Just a perfect day for the skipper. And a perfect day for the new coach, Phil Walsh. And Bruce, not quite a full house today. I should imagine if they can beat Collingwood next week, how big will that crowd be against Melbourne the following?
Absolutely. Zeeble, does he get the right angle? It's coming back. It's a behind. Yep. No.
What has impressed me about Adelaide today? They've had 220 kicks, 119 handballs. In other words, they've moved the ball by 42 for one. Is still a good ratio to really move the ball quickly. That might be dependent on the opposition pressure not being great, and it hasn't been today from the majority of the time by the Kangaroos, but their foot skills to move the ball has been outstanding.
Yes.
Ellis Yeoman. So he's the guy, Lee, Ellis Yeoman, that would probably kick Thompson out of the side, if you think about it.
Very different type of player.
Yeah, but midfield.
Yeah.
But Thompson, I think, will certainly stake a claim this week.
That's your line. Yep, that's it.
We've spoken about their draw. It's a pretty easy start to the year, actually. They only played three games versus top eight sides from last year before the mid-year break. So it's a good start.
Petrie with a lovely long leg. Has it held the line? No, just misses.
Jackie.
Just the one goal for Drew today. real veteran, getting close to 300 games himself.
He did come sixth in their club championship last year, Scott Thompson, so I guess you would think when you're fitting well, there'll be a spot for you.
Yeah.
Brodie Smith to Jacobs, a couple of the real match winners for Adelaide today. It's hard to find a player who's lowered his colours. There's a few of them just dropped their guard a little in that third term, but overall, Yench and other have been superb.
Of course, there's one forgotten member of the Adelaide team, that Brent Riley, of course, who had the terrible accident pre-season, has been a fantastic club man. Be watching on with a great deal of interest today.
He'll be enjoying this, We wish him all the best for his recovery. Smith's kick, not great.
So, what's the situation with Riley?
Well, it was obviously a plate he had inserted in his head a little while ago when he did have that fractured skull. So they haven't made any commitment. They're not even thinking about him returning to football. He's been around the club a little bit over the past few weeks and certainly been buoyed up by all the support from the players, but I wouldn't be thinking about him playing football for a long time.
So Petrie snap after Dangerfield and belt it away. And just finally, the Sodas, is Thompson an absolute automatic selection these days or not?
Well, he would be certainly when he's fit, but like Lee said, obviously their midfield mix at the moment is absolutely fantastic. When Phil Walsh spoke during the week, he was a little cagey and you almost had the feeling that Thompson would be at least included in the squad, but he didn't do that in the end. The other one is Kerridge with a hamstring, and he's probably a week or so behind Thompson.
Good on you, Sodas. Terrific job today. And what about this? Brodie Smith through the middle. He's had four bounces. He pops it over the top for Walker for seven, for a career high. Unselfishly, the handball instead. And Charlie Cameron bangs it through. That's his first.
That was a fantastic run, wasn't it, by Smith? He just charged out of the back up, but he always looked like he was in control. And then at the end of the running, the bounce, when you run and bounce the footy, your forwards really never know what you're going to do. So you've got to find the target. And he actually missed Walker. Walker was about to mark the ball 40 metres out, but ball bounced in front of him and he had his first handball for the day. I thought, popped it over the top.
I thought that was Basil was referring to his first. It was a handball, but not it was Charlie Cameron's goal, was it?
Well, both.
It's a good handball, actually.
It was, actually.
It's a beautiful handball, beautiful
his,
setup.
His skills are huge, aren't they?
Yeah, he's a very talented player, Walker. We know he's good in the air, we know he's a good mark, but he's got beautiful disposal skills as well.
What is it to the North Adelaide end for North Melbourne today? It's been an absolute drought down that end, hasn't it? Douglas sort of cuts it off Laird. So Adelaide really finishing it off. Betts. Gee, they've had some good players. Betts is one of them. Dangerfield and Walker would be one and two. Van Berlo off that step. Kicks to the pocket. Cameron versus McDonald. Betts and Cameron, they work so well together. And Charlie across the ground and out on the full. He's got something, Cameron. He's just 20 years of age, but he's got some real gifts.
Got agility and ball skill and great balance.
Oh, so exciting. Swan Districts in the WAFL. The club that gave us the Narkle brothers. Nick Natanui from Swan Districts. Excitement machines, all of them. Lions got his handball away. High ball in now, Henderson, but offline. So out of bounds on the full. McMillan still barking the instructions out there. Wants some run. What will they salvage from this game, North Melbourne, do you think, Lee? Zeeble, good mark?
Not a whole lot, except I guess they could say from the positive, when we really started to win the footy, move the ball quickly as they did for the first 10 minutes of the third quarter, we can play okay. That's really the lesson for them from the game, I think.
It's another of those games that they are expected to win against teams around them that they have dropped.
And we might look ahead to their next four games, North Melbourne, to come, Lee, so have a look at those.
Brisbane next week, they should win that again. Where they are on the ladder, Port Adelaide's tough, and Geelong and Hawthorn are 50-50 at best.
Well, they...
Not on today's form, probably, they're not 50-50, but...
That looks a tough draw, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That does look a tough draw. If you don't barrack for them and you're completely neutral, I reckon you take two and three after the day when you've got Port Adelaide, Hawthorn and Geelong amongst it, wouldn't you?
Sloan, he's been courageous all day. Eddie Betts has been outstanding. had a couple of bounces. Here's Walker. He's outside 50. So for seven, for a career high, passes off to Jenkins instead. And Jenkins has kicked two. Well, this will be a handy return, won't it, from the two tall forwards. Six from the skipper. And potentially now three from Jenkins. Nine from the Twin Towers. Any team is going to be hard to stop when the tall timber can bag that many.
Nothing like handing a few over once you've kicked six.
Well, career high beckoned, but this will be a nice finish for Jenkins. So he kicks his third, and Adelaide now with the biggest lead of the game. It's 70 points.
Walker's had 14 score involvements lead today.
Oh, he's been outstanding. I mean, really, I know Jude loves the midfielders. Well, I like the key position players.
No, he's brought his own football, hasn't he? He's been unbelievable, Tex Walker.
Well, the 22 disposals, 15 marks, 6 goals, 5. I mean, that's just an outstanding performance if any key position player can get those kind of numbers, unless you're standing in the goal square receiving uncontested marks or something. I reckon when you're playing forward of the footy, as he does, with an opponent on you, every mark's a contested mark.
Yeah.
Because you've got to get off your opponent to get into space.
Yeah.
And he's had basically 18 of those in total. 18 marks.
It's a great way of looking at it, isn't it? So, why do you always make sense, Lee? Anyway, Douglas on the burst. So Adelaide really finishing this off now. And then kicking wide to Cameron. It'll be a hard team to get into next week, I think.
Oh, Jutho plays that well.
And Betts.
Hasn't their use of the ball into the forward 50 been just outstanding? I mean, there was a lot of players back, a lot of Crows players, a lot of Kangaroos players, but Cameron wasn't who had the ball in hand. He just waited till a Crows player presented into the space.
So Betts over 20 disposals, three goals.
15 seconds gone. Yep.
How sweet it is, eh? What a start for the Crows. Betts kicks four. Walker's got six. Dangerfield and Sloan have starred. They've all contributed. Well, we might be seeing the start of something pretty special from this club this year. A long way to go, but they could not have had
an outstanding
start.
Exhibition. The contest in the game, it was there a little bit midway through the third quarter, but then the Crows snuffed that out. But on the other part of the game, I love it when a team is playing really good football, kicking a good score, just the exhibition of the sport. And they've been outstanding today, the Crows. Just been great to watch.
If you take those six goals away from North, Adelaide have kicked 21 of 24 goals. I mean, it's been total domination. So the last seconds in what has been a monumental opening game for the Adelaide Crows here in season 2015. Everything they have touched has turned to goals.
Get 21 goals from 60 inside 50 entries. If you get anything like one out of three, that's about you. It never gets much better than that. That's just been fantastic.
This would just be ridiculous now.
Yeah.
Well, if he goals here, this will be the high score for the Crows at the Adelaide Oval. He's a long, long, long way out. It's a long, long kick. And it's a behind. So the icing was already on the cake. And Tex, well, he's well named because he's big. So Adelaide over North Melbourne by 77 points. Let's go down to the captain with Jude Bolton. Jude?
Yeah, we've got the skipper here. He's kicked 6 goals, 5. He's had 15 marks. Tex, not a bad start of skipper.
Oh, mate, look, we set out to play some team for you today. I thought we'll be patchy at the start. Let him back in, but I think the way we finished off is the way we want to play for four quarters.
You had 5 multiple goal kickers, so you're well supported by Betts and all the rest around you.
Yeah, look, we've had a pre-season under our belt now. We've had a couple now to work together, and I think we're starting to gel just quite nicely.
And what about the pressure and I guess the delivery from upfield? It was just coming in so quick.
I think if we can, as a team, defend together, then I think our when we get the ball in attack, then the rest will take care of itself. So team defence for us, I think we did that really well today.
And what about Phil Walsh? What's he brought to this side?
Oh, mate, he's brought a lot. He's a great guy. He's brought some hardness. He's not happy with some of the things that we did today, but I think he's got a bit of calmness about him as well, and his ability to teach each and every player.
Good luck next week against Collingwood, mate.
Thanks, Drew.
So the exciting thing, I think, if you're an Adelaide Crows supporter, it's not the margin, not the win. It was the way they played. It was thrilling, absolutely. Plenty more still to come here. It's 140-63, Adelaide over North Melbourne.
Schneider goes wide to Savage. A lovely kick of the ball. Need a gem here. Not too bad.
Oh, what?
Not too bad.
What?
Kick a barrel.
Big talk. He's going to have to go for it. Let's have a look at him off the side of the boot and go out.
He's holding it for the talk. Gets a bit on it. Let's respect Art into Sale. Can you believe it? Welcome to your new club, Adam Cooney.
Goes for home. Wait. Hardigan right there with him. Runners arrive. Higgins has kicked one already. How about this for a start? Number two.
Rising the ruck down to Devin Smith. The dangerous around goal. Got clear. Whitfield. He's put it through. So chance of the hour. Memory sets it up. They can all run it.
Oh!
Kicks those goals. Hey, Lingy, what about the matchups in the midfield? Can you see any tags?
Oh, what a grab out there by Buick. Some great elevation.
Walker working with Tippett. Dangerfield's in a good spot. Now a better spot.
Beautiful.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Eddie gets his second.
Screws it back. There's sun's, well, the sun in the eyes, and there's sun's ready to pounce. Riscatelli's kicked one already this quarter. That is even better. That is an amazing goal from Michael Riscatelli.
Well, there's legs.
It looked like it. Going in this gap. Dalhouse again. Oh, something from nothing from Luke Dalhouse. Bingo.
Last night goal for the game is one story. 21 scoring shots to three is the other, Bruce.
Dangerfield to Sloan to kick the opening goal of the match. A second running bounce. No one coming to him. Decides to load up. Walker, goal! He's kicked another one, Sloan.
Opened up for Garland to the skipper, Jones. His 19th disposal could be one of the most important ones of the day. Oh, it's touched by Garland. Right spot, right time, goal.
Carlisle.
Bird.
Oh, it's bending.
A miracle goal.
No way. Never in your wildest dreams.
It's about it. Still thinking. Had the handball in the end. Savage, does he get enough momentum? He has. It's going and it is through.
Wow, what a goal.
To get them home. Dangerfield out of the middle. Start of the final turn down to Walker. Carrito there. Just a chop of the arms. It was clever. How about that follow-up from Dangerfield? It deserves a goal! Yeah. It's already one of the goals of the year.
And what a way to get to Patrick Dangerfield with Jude Bolton. Jude.
Just this this crowd's come to life today. What a way to start round one.
Yeah, great way to start. To have 60,000 fans for the first time in the club's 25-year history is a terrific result. You know, it's been a really long pre-season, full of hard work, and it's good to see we've started the season off on the right note.
But Phil Walsh just preached defence the whole time, and it was really evident early on, that team pressure, team defence, and just allowed the inside 50s from there.
Yeah, that's the only way we're going to win. You know, it's going to be 22 contributors each and every week. Every now and then, players are going to have outstanding games, text tonight. But it was a really good defensive effort tonight, which Walsh would be happy with.
And you got guys like Kerridge and Scotty Thompson outside the group as well?
Yeah, so I'll certainly look to come in. But I think I'm going to have to get in with a silent, which is a great test for the crowd.
Thanks, mate.
Good on you.
What are they doing here, Macca? It looks like some kind of post-game ceremony of some
about
sort.
About to sing the song.
OK.
So it's been 21 years since the Crows have been on top after round one. There's a good chance I'll be there. Well done.